Hi, I'm Barry Switzer of the Oklahoma Sooners. Welcome to the 1978 Orange Bowl in sunny Miami, Florida. We don't have that right now, but we're going to have a great game for you. And I think Lou Holtz has got some magic for you right here.
Well, Barry, you know as well as I do, there is no magic to winning football games. If there was, I sure would have employed what little magic I know an awful long time ago. We're just very happy to be here in the Orange Bowl, and the wonderful hospitality has been extended to us by everybody down here in Miami. Speaking on behalf of the University of Arkansas Athletic Department, fans, alumni, and players, we wish everybody a very happy new year.
NBC Sports is happy to bring you from Miami the 1978 Orange Bowl. The Sooners from the University of Oklahoma versus the Razorbacks from the University of Arkansas. Brought to you by Pontiac. 1978 is Pontiac's best year yet, so come in and price our Pontiacs. By National, the Sunshine Airline. Find out why 3 out of 4 passengers have flown with National before. By the people who bring you the bright, refreshing taste of Coca-Cola. Coke adds life to just about everything you do. And by Goodyear, developers of such tire innovations as the new all-season Tiempo Radial. It has stopped raining. Hello, everyone. I'm Jim Simpson. And what a final day of the collegiate football season. Penn State has reason to believe it can be number one. Alabama, which won the Sugar Bowl today, could be number one. Well, the number one team, Texas, was knocked off, but the Longhorns are 11-1, and so is Notre Dame, which knocked off Texas. Michigan, no longer among the pretenders. But Oklahoma, which starts the day in second place behind Texas, feels that if it wins tonight over Arkansas, it is number one. We will leave that to the game and to the pollsters. I'd like to introduce right now a gentleman who's played in a couple of bowl games, and he says he's never been so charged up as he is for this one tonight.
I think waiting has got me charged up. I know those players are chomping to get out on that field, Jim, but we've got a lot of excitement. It's been a great week for the Orange Bowl here. About 200 players have been royally entertained by the Rose Bowl, or the Orange Bowl committee. I'm sure the Rose Bowl took care of their troops, too. But these young men have enjoyed the dog track. They've been out to see Hialeah. They've seen Miami Beach. And now it's come down to where this game really means something. What an exciting way to finish this week.
We're going to get to the game itself in a moment, but this is not your usual run-of-the-mill rivalry. This is a rivalry that began a long time ago, and we haven't had a game in many, many years. Listen. Tonight's Orange Bowl game between Oklahoma and Arkansas marks the renewal of a football rivalry that began back in the 19th century. It was November 4th, 1899, 8 years before Oklahoma became a state, that these two universities first played football. It was a cold, drizzly afternoon in Shawnee, Oklahoma, the first time that Oklahoma had ever played a rival state university. It was the Oklahoma Rough Riders against the Arkansas Cardinals. The crowd was small, and Oklahoma, which guaranteed the expenses of Arkansas, lost money on the game. The Oklahoma coach, Professor B.L. Parrington, personally made up the deficit. Years later, he was reimbursed, but for only part of the sum. In 1908, at Boyd Field in Norman, Oklahoma, the team officially became known as the Sooners. And that year, the students formed the first organized pep club at the school, encouraged by their coach, Benny Owen. And they were called the Sooner Rooters, and the memberships cost 10 cents. The team of 1908 whipped Arkansas 27-5, but the next season in Fayetteville, Arkansas won 21-6. These forward pass plays drawn up by Coach Benny Owen led Oklahoma to 3 straight victories in 1914, 1915, and 1916 over Arkansas. The 1917 game was played in Fort Smith, where the Razorbacks held the favorite Sooners to a nothing-nothing tie. In 1918, the Razorbacks lost nearly their entire team to military service. And 3 days prior to the game at Oklahoma, students were asked to come out for football so that Arkansas could field a team. The result? Oklahoma, 103. And Arkansas, nothing. The Sooners scored 6 touchdowns in the first quarter. And it was said the big crowd was due to the fact that the Spanish influenza epidemic restrictions were lifted just before the game. The next year, the Razorbacks were ready for the Sooners. There were ads in the Fayetteville Democrat promoting the rematch. And Arkansas pulled off the big upset, winning 7-6. And there wasn't an Arkansas player who weighed more than 175 pounds. Train accommodations were poor, and Oklahoma arrived just 30 minutes before the kickoff. According to a count of the game of the Tulsa World in 1919, Arkansas made free use of the forward pass, but Oklahoma did not try the maneuver often. Sounds more like 1978 instead of 1919, doesn't it? The last meeting between the Sooners and the Razorbacks was 51 years ago, October the 9th, 1926, played on a muddy field in Norman, Oklahoma. And despite their fumbles, Oklahoma won 13-6. Oklahoma holds the edge in this series, 8-3-1. And now, 51 years later, these two border states meet again amid the color and pageantry of the 1978 Orange Bowl game. And so much for past history. Let's bring it up to date. I think everybody knows, Merlin, that the top runner, the top pass receiver of Arkansas, plus one other back, have been suspended. They're not here tonight.
That's going to hurt Arkansas, but certainly they're more concerned about the players that are here, Jim. And they also lost through injury Leotis Harris, a great guard, in fact, one of the finest in the country. And he'll be missed in there sorely. But this Arkansas team is interesting because they've been outmanned on a lot of football fields over the year. They only lost one game, that was to Texas, common opponent to Oklahoma, who also lost to Texas. And the interesting thing about Arkansas is they're so darn tough and quick on defense. They have really done a great job.
Make no mistake about it, Oklahoma says if they win tonight, they're number one. We will find out. Great halftime, but now let's go down for a pregame pageantry.
Given by Coach Frank Broyles, Athletic Director of the University of Arkansas.
Let us pray. Our Father in heaven and in this place, we pause in our secular celebrations to declare the glory of your name and to express our concern that your kingdom might come before all the kingdoms visible in this Orange Bowl. Give us this day and every day the things we need, a generous spirit in victory or in defeat, an undaunted will to give our best at all times and all circumstances, and forgive us when we fail by falling or fumbling or missing our assignment. Lead us not towards those life game plans which result in our final defeat. For yours is the only kingdom that ultimately matters, the power above all powers, the glory above all glories, now and forevermore. Amen.
Country, you bet it is. Stretching from sea to shining sea and rising to touch vast, spacious skies. America the beautiful. Like these agree All-American homecoming queens representing each of the 50 states and the District of Columbia. Here tonight through the courtesy of Johnson's Wax. Thank you. ladies and gentlemen, in addition to the lovely ladies who have come to us from across America, we take pride in presenting our very own beautiful Orange Bowl Queen and Court. We direct your attention to the center of the field to meet Princess Marguerite Atkins. Princess Ana Maria Hernandez Cartilla. Princess Linda McCarthy. Princess Joni Somers. And now, our 1978 Orange Bowl Queen, Her Majesty Zetta Whitlow. Honor America, we invite you to join Miss Sherry Schultz from the Mississippi University for Women and the other All-American Homecoming Queens in the singing of our national anthem.
Our pregame pageantry, and may I say that at halftime we have what we call our spectacular of lights. In the meantime, we have come to the final bowl game of the year, Arkansas and Oklahoma. And on this final night here in the Orange Bowl for the 1978 Orange Bowl, we may find out who, after all, is the national champion. It's all been set up by the undefeated Texas Longhorns for weeks and weeks, number one in the nation, being upset this afternoon by Notre Dame by a whopping 38-10 score. That put it up for grabs. Alabama had an outstanding day against Ohio State, and here's a team that can spoil it for Oklahoma and maybe get a share for themselves. Here come the Razorbacks of Arkansas, and don't forget they are 10-1.
On a weekend with all the surprises we've seen, Jim, Lou Holtz and his Razorbacks would love to hand Oklahoma a surprise here tonight.
Here come the Sooners of Oklahoma, number two as the bowl games began, and they think after tonight they will be number one. You can see them raising their fingers. We are number one. Arkansas will have something to say about that. The temperature expected to drop into the 50s. The rain has stopped. The field is in good condition. And we're ready for the matchup between the University of Arkansas and Oklahoma. Arkansas sent out its four captains, and the entire team followed. Oklahoma sent out its three captains, saw what was going on, and their entire team followed.
I think they're trying to stare each other down out there. It looks like a sumo match out there, Jim. But they are emotional. They have waited a long time for this kickoff. They are excited, and I don't blame them for being out there to see what's going on.
That is referee Pete Williams of the Southeastern Conference showing them the coin that he's going to toss, and we shall find out what is it won the toss.
It looks like Oklahoma will receive.
Oklahoma's won the toss and will receive. Our officials tonight from the Southeastern and Big Ten conferences. Referee is Pete Williams, umpire Frank Strokia, Joe Delaney, the field judge, Line judge is Dick Waterhouse, Bobby Gaston the head linesman, and the back judge, Bill Quinby. There is Lou Holtz, the magician, who took a team that was no better than Even Steven in 1976 and turned it into a 10-1 ball club. And he came up against one of those major coaching decisions where he had to suspend three of his players. Barry Switzer, 51 wins and only four losses in his entire career at Oklahoma and thrown a couple of ties. 38 years old, an amazing record. About 15,000 are here from Arkansas, and 11,000 or 12,000 paid their way here from Oklahoma. It is a sellout crowd in Miami. In a ball game that for a long while had Arkansas off the board, and then they were installed as nearly a three-touchdown underdog. But if you talk to the Razorbacks and to their coaches, they don't think that's right.
They knew they would be underdogs in the game today, and they don't mind that role. They found themselves underdogs a number of times during the season, were able to come out and play the kind of football that allowed them to win consistently. You talk about this matchup, a classic matchup of a tough, stubborn defense against a grinding, powerful offense.
And both have excellent kickers, and you're about to see one right now. That is Steve Little, who holds the record for most field goals with 53, most points. He's kicked a 67-yarder. And only 9 of his 72 kickoffs all year long have been returned. But David Overstreet, number 22, and Freddie Nixon, number 11, are deep. And they would like to give Oklahoma some field position. The Sooners say they are a field position team. They need good field position. They fear Steve Little. Little's kick is short and bounds into the end zone and will come out to the 20-yard line, where it will be first and 10 for Oklahoma. Thomas Lott has a problem with a pulled hamstring, although we took a look at him and he looked like he was running very well. He is the quarterback, Elvis Peacock from Miami, number 4 at left half. Billy Sims, the right halfback, a real speedster, as is Kenny King, the fullback, number 30. The wide receivers, Steve Rhodes, their outstanding wide receiver, and their tight end is Victor Hicks. Oklahoma does not throw much. They give it to King, and King is stacked up at the line of scrimmage. The ball is loose. Riding the ball in, coming down with it is Billy Sims.
Here's the Oklahoma Sooners offensive line. Carl Baldesweiler, number 67, a fine left tackle. Jaime Melendez, 60, is the guard. Paul Tabor, one of twin brothers, the center. Greg Roberts, the other guard. Sam Clapham, 63, a full-blooded Indian on the right-hand side.
Bobby Kimball is brought into play. He is wide to the right. Lott is back down in the backfield. Dragged down by Reggie Freeman, the middle guard. Arkansas is quick, and Oklahoma is just as quick.
Boy, what a job they're doing on defense out there. Jim, I can't believe it. We were told that they'll swarm all over the field. Here's that classic. They fake the first one. He wants it outside. There's just no chance for him. Reggie Freeman there to take away the option and put Lott right on the ground.
That's how Arkansas says they must have a chance. That is to play defense and depend on Steve Little. Rhodes now wide to the right. On third down and 14, and jumping offside is Victor Hicks, the tight end. And now it becomes third down and 19. The first time in 51 years these two teams have met. And how odd it is that when they finally get together for modern day football, the national championship could be at stake. Lou Holtz along the sidelines. There is Rhodes. You will find Rhodes and Kimball and Hover, the split ends, bringing in the play. They'll change. The wishbone formation. King in motion. Sims drops the football. Throws to Arkansas inside the 10. Picked up by Jimmy Walker.
That's big Jimmy Walker with the ball in his hands, and that's one of the dangers of this wishbone offense. You've got to throw it around back there, and that time it slipped loose. Jimmy Walker right on top of him. Watch Lott. Takes the handoff here. Looks like they lose it right there in the handoff itself. Sims tries to get back. No chance. Walker's right on top of the ball. Big break. Great opportunity for Arkansas.
That is what hurt
Oklahoma in the early going. Too many turnovers. Now Cagney is the quarterback, keeping the ball inside the five. Montel Cagney, the junior. Greg Colenda leading the way from his right tackle spot. Here's your backfield, Trent Bryant. Coming in for Ben Cowens, the suspended man. Roland Sales at fullback. The wide receivers, Farrell and Stiggers. Farrell goes wide to the right. Now they have two tight ends. Second down, Kyle Cagney straight ahead, touchdown! Number 21, Roland Sales. What a day for football.
What a way to start this ball game for Arkansas. They get that kind of break. They knew that they were going to have some breaks if they were going to stand toe-to-toe and slug it out with Oklahoma. They got their break, they got the fumble, and they put it in the end zone. That's the way to play football.
Steve Little, who has hit on 37 out of 38 conversions, in to add the extra point. Ball is spotted. He gets a very high loft, and it's right through there, and there's the big turnover. Oklahoma's Billy Sean fumbled it at the nine. Sales took it in. 7-0 the Razorbacks. Barry Switzer along the sidelines. One of the questions he was asked, what effect do you think that nearly a month off from their last game into the Orange Bowl would have on that wishbone offense that was so guilty of fumbling the ball early in the season? They got things together later in the season, but remember, they've had about 4 weeks off before playing tonight.
Certainly one of the things they were concerned about, and they're also going against an old adversary in Monty Kiffin, who calls the defenses for this Arkansas team. He was at Nebraska for about 11 years. They happen to play Oklahoma traditionally at the end of the year. So if anyone understands from a defensive standpoint how to work on Oklahoma, it's probably Monty Kiffin. And he's made some adjustments we'll be talking about later that were surely effective in getting them stopped on that first drive and leading to that big fumble and a big touchdown right afterward.
Steve Little did not have a good kickoff, although it did make its way to the end zone to start the game. He will kick off again. And Freddie Nixon watches it go into the end zone. That's a live ball, but he downs it and will come out to the 20-yard line, and Oklahoma will start all over again. Arkansas was expected to make some adjustments. Whatever they've done thus far, they've been effective in stopping the running game of Oklahoma in the first series.
Well, they knew they couldn't match up Reggie Freeman on the nose in there. They've got just a mismatch physically. So they're moving around. They're taking their nose man, Freeman, and moving him to the outside, bringing their tackles down so they get a big matchup on the center inside against Tabor. Now, this time they haven't made the adjustment. Let's see how they work out of a regular position.
Thomas Lott with the football, pitches back to Sims, and Sims picks up 4 or 5 yards. 5 yards out to the 25-yard line before he's knocked down by Howard Sampson, the good free safety, number 31.
Here's a good look at the wishbone from the end zone. You see the first option there to Kenny King on the inside. Lott then has the option on the second man. Tosses the ball out to Sims. Sims able to get over the top, make an excellent gain before he finally bounces down.
Second down five, Howard, Walker, Freeman, Hampton, and Saxton, the front five for Arkansas. Second man through is Peacock. Peacock breaks into the open. After it's Lusby, Peacock's got speed. Lusby has the angle and knocks him down inside the 40. Vaughn Lusby pulls him down. First down, a 44-yard scamper by Elvis Peacock from Miami. The All-American guard, Greg Roberts, springing him loose.
Elvis Peacock, of course, the fastest of these backs, an incredible speedster, a senior, will go high in the draft this year. You see him cutting back against the grain, and they're lucky, Lusby is lucky to get a hold of him and get him to the ground. You can't give him any room. They've just got so much speed back there, Jim, they'll eat you up.
Oklahoma, a very high-scoring team.
There's a look on the inside. You saw Jimmy Walker on the inside. His responsibility there is shut off the first option.
Look Ooh. Out. Kenny King makes a mistake, and Lott goes down, and they just may take the play here as Lott was thrown for the loss. Larry Jackson and William Hampton are the linebackers. Patrick Martin and Vaughn Lusby, the cornerbacks. Brad Shepp and Les King is now in there at safety as Howard Sampson has gone out.
It looked like Kenny King jumped off when a cannon went off in the end zone. I don't know whose cannon that was. If it's an Arkansas cannon, somebody's going to be upset. It's on the Oklahoma side, though, Jim.
They will take the play and the couple of yard loss. They'll refuse that motion penalty and make it second down and long. Things have happened so quickly here, we've hardly given you either defense. Forrest Valora now comes in, and Hicks goes out.
It looks like we'll see two tight
ends
here.
That's right, they've got two tight ends in.
Oklahoma said they would do this early in the game.
Valora and Hicks are there. Lott with the football, not pitching back across the 30, and down he goes inside the 30-yard line. It'll be third down and about five to go inside the 30-yard line. Les King came up, and Lott, who has had a hamstring problem, is now rolling over, and he is the bread and butter of Oklahoma. Let's see if he's clutching that leg. He had a slight hamstring pull, or whether he just had the wind knocked out of him.
Well, the key to that wishbone offense, of course, is the quarterback, the man who must make it run. Watch him here from the end zone. He comes out, he options on the first man. Coming to the outside, he has the option of either throwing or keeping. And Lott is probably the best runner of all the backs in that backfield. They're all great runners. Lott is perhaps the best, and it looks like he just wrapped up heavy there. They're hoping on the Oklahoma side that he is not hurt, because he certainly, according to Barry Switzer, is the finest quarterback that he's ever had to run this wishbone offense, and that's saying a great deal.
Well, in their opening games against Vanderbilt and Ohio State, they had some trouble when Lott was not around. And that is a handkerchief or kerchief that he wears under his helmet, and when asked why he wears it, he said for pub. And we asked, what is pub? And he said, pub is publicity. And he's got a lot of kerchiefs that he uses, and so now we have Dean Blevins coming in, a senior out of Norman, Oklahoma, who is not the runner that Lott is. Rhodes is back in. They've gone away from the two tight end offense, and Rhodes goes wide left. 7-0 Arkansas in the first 5 minutes of the game.
Whoa!
Peacock is met head on. Reggie Freeman down at the bottom of the stack, along with Jim Howard.
Well, they just put Howard into the middle of that backfield, and he just took away the option entirely. Watch him come out of the left side of your screen. Now that's Freeman. He's coming out of the outside. He just nailed him right in the backfield. Help from Jimmy Walker and Howard coming in the secondary. Another adjustment by Kiffin. Boy, was that a beautiful shot.
Fourth down, and now Uwe von Schaumann is coming in to try a 45-yard field goal, which will be no good, and Arkansas has held the highly favored Sooners of Oklahoma. But we've got a lot of time left, even in this first quarter. 10:48 left here in the 1978 Orange Bowl. Arkansas by 7. Well, this is the new year, and the new PGA Tour of 78 begins this weekend. Starting on Thursday, they'll tee it up in the Joe Garagiola Tucson Open. I'll be there with all the foot soldiers on Saturday and Sunday afternoon with our first coverage of the first tournament of 1978, defending champion Bruce Litsky. Now let's see if Arkansas can move the football. They had it on the 9. Cal Cagney is going to throw, puts it up, headed for Duckworth, who is there, and the ball drops. And Duckworth is double-teamed by the All-American Zach Henderson, and also back there was Mike Babb, the right cornerback. It'll be second down and 10. Duckworth.
He's a real flyer, Jim. He can run a 9-7. He's also the decathlon champion of the state of Arkansas. High jump, 6'9½". They say he's probably the finest overall athlete on this Arkansas team.
He's the man who caught a 59-yard touchdown pass to win over Texas Tech in the season's finale. Ron Calcagney put it up for grabs on first down 10, holds onto the football, and gets outside for 3 or 4 yards. And a word before we get it, and they forget it in the excitement of the game. Ron Calcagney was a tailback at Youngstown, Ohio, when Matt Kavanaugh of Pittsburgh fame was the quarterback. When Kavanaugh graduated, went on to become an All-American at Pittsburgh, they said to Ron Calcagney, we want you to be the quarterback. He didn't want to be. He would rather be the tailback. But here he is, an outstanding quarterback. He's got third down and 7. Calcagney back to throw, loops it out for Sales. Sales has the first down and more. The touchdown maker's out to the 37-yard line. First down, Arkansas. Darrell Hunt, Sherwood Taylor made the tackle.
Arkansas taking advantage of the fact that these Oklahoma linebackers are so quick. They get those great drops, running a hot receiver out of there, dropping the ball right over the hot top of the lineman, and running it down in for the first down. Let's look at the linemen quickly. Bruce Tatum, Dave Hutchins, moving on down to Reggie, where are we, guys? Paul Tabor, Jaime Melendez, Carl Ball is fighter.
I'll clear it up for you. We're in the Orange Bowl.
Go ahead,
Jeff. We're in the Orange Bowl is where we are. Trent Bryant carried that ball. By the way, as you looked at that defense, be aware that there are four bona fide All-Americans in that defense. Here is Terry Peters, Mike Babb, Sherwood Taylor, and Zach Henderson has been a starter since a freshman, and he is the fourth All-American. Cumbie and Hunt and Kinlaw are the other three. Second down and about six to go. Cal Cagney carries the football and is near the first down across the 45-yard line. He'll be very close to the first down. And Ron Cal Cagney has put the bulk of the offense squarely on his own shoulders. He's run with the ball and he has thrown the football.
Lou Holtz, of course, calls the plays for Arkansas, but he'll be the first to tell you that the man who has to make things work out there is Cal Cagney. Here you get an idea of Cal Cagney's quickness. Follows the diving back in there, up over the top. Excellent job of running. Fine gain. Going to be second and very short down there. Very short.
Very short.
Oh, 3 inches, Jim, I think.
7-0 Arkansas when Billy Sims fumbled at the 9. It was recovered at the 9 by Jimmy Walker, and later Sales took it in.
I shouldn't have said second. It's going to be third down. But let's see what Lou Holtz has up his sleeve here. He's not above going for a big one on third and short.
Third and a couple of inches. You would think Cal Cagney, wouldn't you? That's what you would think. And that's who's got it, and he's got the first down. Cal Cagney carries out near midfield. First down, Arkansas. 8:57 to go, first quarter.
They like the right side of their line. They like to go in there behind Colinda, the fine tackle, and Mark Lewis, who is over there subbing for the injured Leotis Harris. But that's been their favorite spot all year behind Harris. Now they're over there behind Lewis and Colinda.
First and 10, they mark the ball at the 49. Al Cagney hands the ball off, and that is Trent Bryant. Trent Bryant is a freshman from Arkadelphia, Arkansas, who was called on to play when Ben Cowens was suspended from the team. The three men that Lou Holtz suspended from the team between them had scored 23 touchdowns during the regular season, and when they were suspended, that's what put Oklahoma even more in the favorites role. And now Bruce Hay is wide to the right. Second down, 9. Cal Cagney, look out, Cal Cagney, he gets away, throws it, has a man open. It is Charles Gray, the tight end, first down, 30-yard line, Arkansas.
Cal Cagney is one of those unusual quarterbacks who seems to have an innate ability to know how to get away from that on-rushing lineman. And he got away here from what looks like a certain sack at 76. That's Richard Murray coming in there, unloads the ball. He's got a receiver open. That's Charlie Clay. Boy, did he get swarmed under, but not until he got that precious first down on the 30-yard line.
Stiggers and Farrell are to the left. Cal Cagney carries the football himself again for a couple of yards, and that is about all. Stacked up there, you can see George Cumbie, the All-American, down at the bottom.
Cumbie's an amazing football player. He's not big as a linebacker goes, but he runs a 4.44.
As we look at Lou Holtz, I'm reminded what Morris McLemore of Miami said about him the other day. He's the perfect size for a coach. If he wins, he's light enough to pick up and carry off the field. If he loses, he blends in with the student manager.
He can hide anywhere, I think.
There is Sale.
Come on.
The touchdown man, and he gets down to the 25-yard line. And it'll be third down and 5 to go, as Oklahoma, remember, has its own outstanding defense. Oklahoma, in your picture right now, is battling for what could be the national championship. Texas beaten today. Third down and 5.
Excuse me, Jim. Oklahoma has an interesting concept. They flip-flop their ends. Tatum, number 5 that you'll see in there, is actually almost a linebacker. Gets out of there on the weak side, and they keep
Look out.
Keep Reggie Mathis, number 58, on their strong side. He's the man that they want to face the run. Let's see what happened down in there. Cal Cagney is saying it's on those guys.
That's what it is, Oklahoma, and that'll take them very close to the first down. Looked like George Cumbie and Darrell Hunt, the linebackers, both were coming.
Looked like they might have had a blitz on the inside, Jim, and a little over-eager in there. Jumped in too soon. You got to look at it from the end zone. You can see the two linebackers blitzing, both Hunt and Cumbie. Sure enough, they were in that neutral zone when that ball was snapped. No chance to get back.
That's the first down at the 20-yard line, and both Tim Adams and Charles Clay, two tight ends are in there. Both clubs expected to use a double tight end offense tonight on many occasions. Now Cagney follows Sales and
Ball is loose.
And belongs to Oklahoma. Picking it up is Darrell Ray, number three, a cornerback.
Cal Cagney fighting for that extra yardage, just simply could not hang on to it.
6:15 to go. Turnovers have been costly, but this one is one that Oklahoma is glad to see because Arkansas turned it over. 7-0, Razorbacks.
Cal Cagney takes the snap here. He's going to dive into the right side behind his diving back. He's got a little bit of room, and up over the top, it looks like he gets it knocked out on the extra effort. Just a fine defensive play. Somebody put their helmet right on the football. Big turnover for the Oklahoma Sooners.
There's Ron Calcagni along the sidelines. Oklahoma has the football. They trail 7-0. Thomas Lott is back in. Remember, he was shaken up, and Blevins had to come in for a play or two. He hands off to King, and King goes straight up the middle and picks up big yardage, and Oklahoma will have second and short. Howard Sampson. And if you ask anybody at Arkansas about their outstanding secondary, many consider it the best in the conference and one of the best in the country. Howard Sampson hurt his wrist, it looked like, on that long run by Elvis Peacock. He's been taken to the dressing room and has not come back out yet. Let's pause briefly for station identification. This is the NBC television network. Second down short, Elvis Peacock has the first down, breaks into the secondary, and down he goes at the 32. Peacock having quite a homecoming. Jaime Melendez, the left guard, broke it open for him.
We told you earlier about the great speed in this backfield, and this particular gentleman happens to have a great deal of it. Peacock, reading the hole well, breaks in behind the block of Melendez, spins off that, excellent body control. He's fighting for everything he can get. Great run.
Peacock has already rambled for 52 yards on just three carries. First down for the Sooners. Lott with the football. Lott across the 40. Falls down as he hits near midfield. Remember, it rained much of the afternoon. The rain has stopped, but the field remains slick. And it's another first down for the Sooners.
Oklahoma is so quick that they can get outside of this very quick defense. You see them stopping. That was Kenny King stopping the penetration and really making it possible for Lott to break outside. He just hit a soft spot on that turf, goes to the ground of his own accord, and he's not happy at all.
Ball is marked at the 46-yard line. First down, 10, Oklahoma. First man through, King, still on his feet, and King has another first down to the 40-yard line, and there's a fumble the second time. Oklahoma has turned it over. Dan Hampton, number 86, recovered. Sims has fumbled, and now King has fumbled. And that's been the bugaboo of the Sooners in the early going.
Anytime you toss that football around, you're going to have trouble with it, but that was just a straight handoff play, that first handoff to Kenny King right up the middle. He's got himself some running room. He's hit by William Hampton there. Finally, back down from the offside, they just stripped the ball out of his hands. There it is, another big turnover.
First down, Calcagney breaks out of a mess and gets across the 45 and out near midfield. It'll be second down and short for the Razorbacks. Both teams are 10-1 starting tonight's game.
Well, Lou Holtz talked about some magic at the beginning of the show. Calcagney's going to show you some magic right here. How he gets out of there, I don't know. Watch this. Right up the middle. I've really been impressed with his quickness. He's moving about as quick as anybody on that field. He's run seven times now for 38 yards. Wow.
Second down and three to go, and Trent Bryant gets close to the first down. It'll be third and short yardage. To repeat again, if you have not heard, if you've been out of the house, or if you've had earplugs in and your eyes shut, Texas was beaten today soundly by Notre Dame, Alabama, clobbered Ohio State, Michigan lost in the Rose Bowl, and now Alabama, Penn State, Texas, and Notre Dame and are all 11-1, and the winner tonight will be 11-1. Now Cagney pitches it back. Brett Bryant, the freshman, is outside, has the first down. Back down by Sherwood Taylor. But the freshman from Arkadelphia picks up the first down at the 43 of Oklahoma. 3:31 to go, first quarter. A balmy night in Miami with the temperature expected to drop into the 50s.
Jim, the beer and the wishbone share one thing. That quarterback has to be able to read and has to be able to execute the option. Calcagni did a beautiful job of getting it off there, getting it out to Bryant on the outside. He got a big gain out of it. They're moving it again.
Sprinter Barnabas White is in there, and that's Barnabas White. He's got great speed, and down he goes. Slipping as he tried to cut. Got near the 40-yard line. It'll be second down and long.
Now, if we were the cheating kind, we'd tell you what's going on down there. Coach is in there giving them a little lecture about how they better get going on offense and put some points on the board.
Second down, nine to go. Farrell comes left. Hay goes to the right.
And here's how Arkansas is going to stop.
Calcagni hands the ball off, and there goes Sales. Sales to the 10, to the 5, and down to the 3 goes Roland Sales. First and goal to go, Arkansas. Mark Lewis was playing right guard because Leotis Harris tore up his knee in practice, made the big block for Roland Sales.
Here's the shot. Arkansas has made their living on the hard dive all year, and that's Roland Sales executing it to perfection. Zach Henderson over, missing the tackle. Sales turns on the speed. Well, that's a great saving tackle by Peters there coming across from the other side, or he'd have been in the end zone.
Farrell goes wide to the right. First and goal to goal. Ball is on the 3. Now Cagney hands it off. And Roland Sales takes it down to the 1. The national championship might be Oklahoma's for the winning of tonight's game. Arkansas, at least an 18-point underdog. It's only the first quarter, but it's a Razorback 7, Oklahoma nothing, and second and goal to go from the 1 for Arkansas. Calcagni carries a touchdown!
Calcagni capped it all off. The safest play in football in short yardage. He just took it from the center, went right in behind the wedge, and packed it over into the goal line. I'll tell you, he's impressive as a quarterback. Quick of foot, strong of body. He's done a great job.
Steve Little in the try for the extra point. 58 yards on 7 plays. The last yard by Calcagni. The kick is good. Remember, Oklahoma is a high-scoring team. But remember also, Arkansas has allowed over the year less than 9 points per ball game.
Here's the touchdown again. Watch Calcagni get the great jump on that ball, and he just powers his way into that end zone. That's good foot. That's good work up front. Give him some credit for that offensive line. Herman and on the other side, Lewis. Center's in there doing a fine job of moving him out, giving him a little room to squeeze into that end zone.
Is anybody saying that this reminds them of the start of the Rose Bowl today when highly favored Michigan found itself down 14 to nothing?
Well, we might have that kind of finish, too. I'll tell you, you can believe this. Oklahoma is a very confident team. They're not about to quit on the other side of that line, and they've got enough horsepower. They put more than 50 points on an average in the last 4 games on the board, Jeff.
Well, they had 62 against Utah, 35 Iowa State, 42 Kansas State, 61 Oklahoma State, 52 against Colorado and 38 against Nebraska.
But they better start now. They better get it on.
Little. Arkansas said they're going to depend on defense and the kicking of Little. Look at that kick. That's out of the end zone. In the air. Little says he would like to be drafted by Denver. He eloped to Aspen, Colorado. But the way I hear it, by the time Denver gets a chance to pick, he's going to be gone on that first round.
He'll be long gone, I'm afraid. I've never seen him kick the ball higher than that. Senior Bowl.
Senior Bowl coming up on Saturday, January the 7th at 2 o'clock. Among those invited, Doug Williams of Grambling. Earl Campbell of Texas. The running back, Terry Miller.
Benjamin will be there from Stanford, too, won't he? Jim, two fine quarterbacks in that game.
First down, Oklahoma. Second man through Peacock. Another dazzling run by Peacock for a first down. Across the 30, out to the 34-yard line, goes Elvis Peacock. Peacock is a man that came out of Miami, went to Oklahoma, and found himself in the role of a blocker for little Joe Washington, now with San Diego. When Washington graduated, they gave the ball to Peacock. Outstanding as a junior and an outstanding senior year. First down, Oklahoma at the 33. Rhodes goes wide left. 1:10 to go, first quarter. Fumbles have hurt the Sooners again. Peacock again. A couple of yards this time across the 35, and that is about all. There is Steve Little along the sidelines, and I think down the bottom of the pile you will find Jimmy Walker and William Hampton.
Jimmy Walker, the finest of these down linemen for this Arkansas team. They really are not big enough to go head-to-head, as we said earlier, with this big Oklahoma line, but they're really making up for it with some smart defense and some very aggressive and quick play on the inside.
And now, as Arkansas has done on several occasions, so does Oklahoma, go to the two tight end offense. Delora joins Hicks at tight end. Second man through is Sims, and Sims gets across the 40-yard line. It'll be third down and a couple of yards to go. And this may have been the last play of the first quarter, which has been a surprising first quarter, to say the least. I'm sure in Arkansas they're jumping up and down, and I'm sure in Oklahoma they're saying, come on, fellas, let's get going. That's what's going to happen. This clock is going to wind down to the end of the first quarter. And what a surprising end it has been. Arkansas taking advantage of a couple of fumbles and some good play, leads 14 to nothing. In the Orange Bowl, I'm Jim Simpson with Merlin Olsen. Oklahoma, 102 yards. Arkansas, 131. The turnovers have been the big story. We begin the second quarter. And at halftime, if you haven't had enough spectacular first half, we've got that spectacular in lights. It is third down for Oklahoma, 3 yards to go. First man through is King. And King goes down. Lott held on to the football, never got it away to King, and Lott was tackled and he'll have to kick it away.
Well, I'd say there's some tough play on that line of scrimmage. They're blowing each other apart down in there, and mean on both sides. We're going to have to see if they can keep this pace through a full football game.
Mark Lucky, and they recruited him to be only a snapper, and he's in there to snap the ball now to Uwe von Schaumann, who will kick it away to Paul Lusby. Rushes on. Lusby says, I want a fair catch at the 26-yard line, which he has. First down and 10 is a flag back upfield, so hold on for just a moment. A 36-yard kick, but there's a flag back upfield. We'll take a look at Pete Williams, who says that Arkansas was offside.
Oh, boy. 5 yards. Will that give him a first down?
Arkansas offside. It'll be very close to a first down.
I believe it'll give him a first down. It looks like they've got a little less than five to go. What a costly mistake. Lou Holtz is going to be very unhappy on the sideline with that, Jim.
Well, the aggressive play, I guess that's what brings about penalties such as that. They've been firing off the ball and fired off a little too soon. Oklahoma on one occasion was also very guilty. They're still talking it over. It'll be very close. They will either just make it or just miss it when they step off the 5 yards.
Looks like the official is going over to walk it off. And, of course, Lott is over there winning. That's Peacock over there checking it out. He's showing him where the half, where the 5 yard mark is. Bad snap on that last punt, and they were lucky they didn't get it blocked, and that might have been the reason for the offsides. It looked like they were coming with a large number of people to try and block the punt. Arkansas does that frequently. They have apparently accepted the penalty, have they?
Well, I thought I saw Peacock holding up a hand fourth down.
He goes over to talk to the coach. Here, you decide, coach. You decide. It's your choice. I'll tell you, I used to be a captain out there. Occasionally, I wouldn't look at the coaches. I wanted to make the choice on the field.
Lou Holtz on this side, and they're holding up. It is a fourth down. That's what Peacock was showing to Switzer when he held up his hand. It's fourth down.
Well, it does give him a chance to better that punt. The punt only went 36 yards, and they usually kick it better than that.
They may not kick it. Peacock is in there.
Well, now they're going to measure it. Good going.
I want to know just how big a gamble they've got. Not much, is it?
No, it isn't. And you're right, Jim. They have got the offensive unit in there. They may decide just to go for the money right here.
The score is Arkansas 14, Oklahoma nothing. We're early in the second quarter. It is fourth down, and they've got the offensive unit in there as the offside may or may not prove costly to Arkansas, may or not may not prove beneficial to Oklahoma. It all depends on what happens on this play. Fourth down, injured. Lott carries. First down out to the 45-yard line goes Thomas Lott behind Tabor and Roberts. Oklahoma keeps the football.
Greg Roberts is an All-American guard, and Tabor, one of the finest down linemen on this offensive unit for Oklahoma. And they just blew themselves some room in there for Lott, who laid himself over the top. Excellent call, and Barry Switzer has come out of that conservative mold. That's a pretty gambling kind of call for him to make, certainly this early in the game.
Bobby Kimball wide right. Lott keeps the football, breaks one tackle, and does not break the second. That is Les King, who pulls him down at the 47 after a gain of two. It'll be second down and eight.
Even though Dan Hampton, number 86, did not make that tackle, he was able to get an arm on Lott, held him up long enough. You watch him right here. Just jumps over the top, hooks him by the jersey, holds on long enough to slow him down. By that time, the inside-out pursuit is there. They put him on the ground.
The best weapon that the Sooners have had all night is Elvis Peacock. Rhodes goes wide right. Peacock now sets up just off the left end. Second down and long. And Lott, look here, going to throw the ball. So far he'll run, and it'll cost him for throwing out a yard. He looked downfield. There were only two receivers downfield, and there were four defensive backs back there with him. And it's third down and seven to go.
Well, they say Lou Holtz says it's the best defensive backfield he's ever seen.
That's Howard Sampson right there.
That's one of them right there. So they're operating with one arm tied behind him.
And I could read his lips. He says, "Hi, Mom, I'm okay."
Well, I'm sure that there are a lot of people be concerned about that young man. He's a senior. He'll probably be drafted very high come this fall. There are a lot of pro teams interested in him.
Third down and long, about seven. Lott hands off, and a flag goes down. And it looked as though Oklahoma was pulling and moving before the snap of the ball. But you make it third down and 12.
Jim, you mentioned the problem with fumbling early in the year. The other problem they had was being a little too eager, being in motion, getting off a little bit before the ball. And you just saw that it hurt them here again. Third and about seven, and it's going to be about third and 12. And that's a long ways for a team that likes to put it on the ground.
Each team has turned the ball over tonight. That, of course, has been more costly to Oklahoma, and each team has come up with the penalties when they should not. And Ron Calcagni thus far tonight has had an outstanding night. He has led them to two touchdowns, scoring one himself. Third and 12. That is Kenny King in motion. And Lott dropping straight back. Pressure's on. Lott sets up the screen to Elvis Peacock. Peacock across the 50. Peacock's got the first down. Lost the football. And Oklahoma, I believe, jumps on it at the 43-yard line.
That was Paul Tabor, number 73, who was down there trying to block for Peacock. Very alertly just snapped that ball up off the ground. Little screen pass. Excellent play. You'll see it developing here. Lott's back. They'll let the defensive line penetrate. Lott drops it off to number four, Peacock. And with his great speed, he's got all kinds of room. Now watch him strip the ball out of his hands right there. Peacock said, look at it. Here's another angle. Coming across, that's Brad Schaap, number 40, who knocked it down. Excellent pickup by Tabor.
Sims has fumbled, King has fumbled, and now Peacock has fumbled. All three of the running backs have fumbled. Lott, hands up, short game. Elvis Peacock to the 41-yard line. A pickup of a yard or so, and the cannon goes off again.
That was some great ball handling by Lott. Peacock actually slipped on the way back from the line. And when he delivered the ball to Peacock, he had it instead of up where it should have been, about a foot and a half lower. Peacock adjusted very quickly and kept from fumbling that ball. Fine reactions on his part.
There's the cannon they fire across the way, along to the Boomer Sooners. Second down. Lott rides King into the line, and King gets down to the 37-yard line. It'll be third down. 11:05 to go in the half. Arkansas up by 14. Well, I'll tell you something. I'm sure that Arkansas is having problems tonight following the ball handling of Thomas Lott. And I also feel sorry for our NBC expert camera crew, because that's a tough assignment with Thomas Lott down there, I guarantee you. Again, they go to the two tight ends. Victor Hicks is joined by Forrest Valora on third down and a long four. Lott, second man through. Peacock, first down to the 31-yard line. And the Sooners are beginning to put it together. They went for the first down, remember, after the penalty on the punt. And they move the ball down now to a first down at the 31. And this Orange Bowl is a madhouse.
They're taking advantage, I think, Jim, of the fact that they do have about a 7 pound per man advantage physically, offensively, over the defensive line of Arkansas.
Lott, a couple of yards inside the 30-yard line. Peacock already has 76 yards rushing.
Lott breaking out of there. Actually, you get a look at him here. Exercises the first option, sees a hole inside, and trips over his own man right there. Otherwise, he might have popped up through there for more yardage still.
Second down and 8 to go from the 29. And this is by far and away the closest that Oklahoma has moved in Arkansas territory. Bobby Kimball goes wide to the right. Remember, Kimball and Rhodes are alternating, bringing in the play. Lott, quick pitch back, whistles low.
I think it's too much time. Too much time. Delay a game, Jim.
Another costly penalty. It'll make it second down and 13. Jerry Saxton was right with Peacock, but by that time, the play had stopped.
Well, again, we're seeing an overshift to the strong side as these Arkansas defensive magicians out there try and put the stop on that wishbone, which is not easy. Lott comes out of there with the option at each turn to give or to keep. And I'll tell you, it's tough because he reads so well. He's actually like making up the plays as he goes according to the strict order of how it must be done.
Second down, 13 to go.
Whoa, reverse, whoa!
That is Jim Howard, the left end, who followed Peacock all the way and dumped him back at the 45-yard line. The sophomore.
You're going to get another look at it here. This is a quick reverse. They want to misdirect against this Arkansas team because of their quickness. But Howard, who was coming from the outside, just was not fooled, turned himself upfield very quickly and made a great tackle on Peacock. That's one of the finest plays we've seen all night.
Kenny King has gone out. And we have two wide receivers in there as Lott goes back, slips, and is down at the 45. The line of scrimmage is the 31 of Arkansas, and they spot the ball at the 46 of Oklahoma.
Well, we did have some rain, but I was just thinking, Jim, I don't think I've ever seen Oklahoma with that kind of yardage to gain unless it was by penalty. They've lost all that yardage almost on their own.
At Oklahoma, should they win tonight, and should they win impressively tonight, would have a valid reason to say we are national champions. They better get on track in a hurry. Von Schaumann kicks the ball to Lusby, who has it at the 15-yard line, the fair catch, and Arkansas takes over after that 39-yard punt. A surprising night so far, 8:24 to go in the half, 14-0 Arkansas. There's our Goodyear blimp overlooking the blackness that surrounds the Orange Bowl, which is all lights and will be spectacular lights at halftime. Ron Calcagni is sitting this one out. Houston Nutt has gone in. Calcagni apparently is all right. They're just substituting, keeping their men fresh. And going straight ahead is Barnabas White for a couple of yards. White is in there along with Robin Smith.
Well, he's got a whole bunch of new troops in there, a whole bunch of fresh troops, Jim. And this is something that Lou Holtz has done over the year. He's put his second unit almost intact. Looks like he's done it here in this game, too. They love him for it.
Looks like Mark Lewis remains in the ballgame at right guard. Everybody else is new. Wilbur, Moon, Burlingame, Locke, Adams, and of course Barnabas White and Robin Smith with Houston Nutt at quarterback. And now we see that Hay and Farrell are in.
That is almost a complete unit in there, isn't it?
Kinlaw has come out at middle guard, and that is Kinlaw across the way. I don't know whether he's shaken up or not, but Richard Murray will switch over to take.
He just broke his helmet, broke his strap or a face mask. He'll be coming back in. You see him adjusting it on the sideline, Jim. But one thing, Lou Holtz, his philosophy about putting a second team in like that, he said, if these guys are going to practice and work, I'm going to give them a chance to play. And talking to some of his players and some of his assistant coaches, the morale on this team, which has been one of the keys to their strength during the season, had been great because of it.
Thomas Lott along the sidelines. Both Robert Farrell and Bruce Hay come wide to the right on second down long. Houston Nutt, believe it or not, is going to put it up in the air. Has a lot of time. Now running out of time. And now the ball is up for grabs and cannot be caught by Terry Peters at the 45-yard line. Now Houston Nutt, in his career as a running quarterback for Arkansas, has lost 78 yards. So you don't expect him to take off and run with the football. He had all kinds of time, but nobody to throw to. And well, finally put the ball up for grabs.
No, I think Wilt Chamberlain would have had trouble getting that one on the sideline. He put it out of bounds. He threw it as far as he could, Jim.
Tim Adams comes in as the tight end, and Charles Clay goes out. 7:38 to go on a third and nine play. Houston Nutt from behind is dragged down, and that looks like number 58, Reggie Mathis, who did it. And now, for the first time today, the kicking foot of Steve Little, who was fourth in the nation in punting, becomes very needed.
Here's another shot of it. You see Reggie Mathis coming from the backside. He's just too strong for that block. Comes right in behind and just puts Nutt on the ground. Big play, and that's one of the first times we've seen this Oklahoma defense flex its muscles here tonight.
And now Little will be kicking the ball away. Not an outstanding punt. It is called for a fair catch by Zach Henderson, one of the up men. Henderson takes it at the 47. Oklahoma with 6:56 to go in the half has excellent field position, but they need it. They're down by two touchdowns.
Your Pontiac dealer's got a surprise for you. A sporty economy car with EPA estimates of 34 miles per gallon highway, 24 city. A sticker price of $35.41, and it looks like this. It's Pontiac's beautiful Sunbird with a spunky 2.5-liter four-cylinder engine and an interior like this. 35.41. Surprised? It's one more reason to see your Pontiac dealer and price our Pontiacs.
Who is the number one investment firm in the East? Who is the number one investment firm in the Midwest? Who is the number one investment firm in the South? Who is the number one investment firm in the West? You know who. Merrill Lynch. All around America, more investors turn to Merrill Lynch than any other investment firm. Sure, there are lots of investment firms, but there's only one Merrill Lynch.
Jim Simpson, Merlin Olsen are both saying what you might be saying. Isn't that beautiful? And taking a look at the lights at halftime, we've got that Walt Disney spectacular of light that is indeed spectacular. First down, Oklahoma at the 47 of Arkansas, 6:56 to go in the half. Lott on a pitch back to Peacock. Peacock simply outruns one man and picks up 8 or 9 yards. He simply ran by the charging Reggie Freeman.
Well, I wouldn't expect Reggie, who's a nose man, to be able to run with him, but I certainly was impressed with the speed of William Hampton, 82, who's coming from a linebacker position and ran almost step for step with Peacock, finally put him out of bounds. But not until he had about a 6-yard gain, 6.5 maybe.
Couple of tight ends in there now for Oklahoma, Hicks and Ballora. Let's call it second down and four. Give Peacock 6 yards. Lott has the football, and Arkansas has Lott back at the 45-yard line. That play was stacked up, and Thomas Lott couldn't make the handoff he wanted to make. Came away with the football and was thrown for a loss.
One of the keys to that wishbone is that long ride of that fullback. Well, that fullback got hit right in the middle of that ride. Lott had a hard time pulling the ball out. Consequently, was pulled down and sacked for a pretty healthy loss. Looks like about an 8-yard loss. No, not that far. 4-yard loss. Going to be 3rd and 8.
Third down. Kenny King. Ball is handed in there for a very short gain. Elvis Peacock getting up. And that's been one of the few times that Peacock, a native of Miami, has not picked up good yardage. And now suddenly, after the loss of Lott and the short gain by Peacock, it is fourth down. And despite the good field position, Oklahoma will have to kick the ball back to Arkansas. And Cal Cagney remains along the sideline.
He's buttoning up the strap, so I think you're going to see him coming back into the game.
Oklahoma in seven third down situations has made a first down only once. Bob Schulman kicks it deep.
Boy, he got his foot on that one. Wow.
Bounds into the end zone and will come out to the 20-yard line. First and 10 Arkansas from the 20. 5:24 to go. It's still a surprise, folks, because Arkansas still leads 14-0 over Oklahoma. That's the 1978 Orange Bowl, but how many remember back to 1951 here in the Orange Bowl? It was Miami and Clemson, and they set a record that year when Bob Schneidenbach passed to Ed Lutz, and Lutz carried the ball a total of 72 yards, and that is the longest pass play of an Orange Bowl in history. 1951. First and 10 for Arkansas, sending both Hay and Farrell to the left. The number one unit of Cal Cagney, Bryant and Sales and company are back in. Nolan Sales is knocked down after a yard gain and hit down hard by Reggie Kinlaw, the All-American middle guard, who, like so many others, surprisingly enough, on the Oklahoma team from Miami, Florida. Peacock is from Miami, and so is his backup, Freddie Nixon.
Interesting.
And so is Reggie Kinlaw.
Interesting on that play, Jim. We talked about the adjustments that Arkansas is making. On that particular play, Oklahoma jumped out of their odd defense to an even defense, put Kinlaw over the guard, and I think confused Arkansas. I think that's why Kinlaw was able to make such a fine play.
Cal Cagney pitches back to the freshman, Bryant. Bryant just does get back to the line of scrimmage, and maybe not that far. Sherwood Taylor's in there to make the stop along with Phil Tabor, who is the twin brother of the center, Paul Tabor.
And I'll tell you, Phil Tabor, again, showing us some remarkable speed for a big man as he was pushing hard from the inside and matching almost stride for stride, someone that should have been able to outrun him comfortably. The speed of these two teams, absolutely incredible. The size and speed, especially of this Oklahoma team, but the overall team speed of both teams are very impressive.
Third down and 9 to go. And Cal Cagney, there's a willingness to put it up, throws it at the feet of his intended receiver, and that is Charles Clay, the tight end. And now Steve Little will come in to kick the ball away. In case you have not heard, in the other major bowls today, the winners were Notre Dame over Texas, Alabama over Ohio State, and Washington upset Michigan. And the folks in the Big Ten cannot be too happy tonight. Freddie Nixon deep as Steve Little will kick the ball away. Did not get a good punt last time. Gets into this one, sends it high. It'll be called for a fair catch along the way by Lee Hover back at the 41-yard line. Timeout again on the field. 3:58 to go and Arkansas up by 14.
22nd, and that will be just one of the very exciting segments that you'll have a chance to see.
First down, Thomas Lott carries the football for about 3 yards. It'll be second down and 7 from the 43. I understand that you were out-muscled in that tug-of-war.
I will tell you this, Jim. At the end of about 2 minutes of tugging, I have never been that exhausted in my life. And those guys tug time after time. They pulled best 2 out of 3 against 14 or 15 teams during that day.
I
gained new respect, let me tell you that.
Second down and 7 to go. Clock is running 3.5 minutes to go in the half. Thomas Lott dropping back. Throws it over this one, and it is dropped by Victor Hicks, the tight end. Well, they don't throw the ball too often at Oklahoma, but Hicks had that. Looked like he was turned the wrong way and simply dropped the ball, but it hit him in the hands.
Well, Thomas Lott is not known as a passer, but he has had 4 touchdown passes this year and can throw the ball, and he has this pass right on the money. Hicks is open, and they've had trouble hanging on to the ball at Oklahoma this year. Not his fault. Interesting thing, after he dropped that pass, Lott came over to him and said, "That's all right. Don't worry about it. We'll get it."
Hicks goes out on another wide receiver. Bobby Kimball comes in. Lott throws the ball and over the head of Steve Rhodes, who was absolutely in the clear at the 27-yard line. And Thomas Lott knows that he had a possible 6 and certainly great field position. But it's fourth down.
You get another look at it here. Lott wanted the quick option. It wasn't open. He read it beautifully. Saw the opening downfield. Just put it over the outstretched arms of Steve Rhodes. He's got to walk off there with his head hanging a little bit. Perfect chance to get back in this game a little bit.
Von Schaumann kicks the ball away.
Oh.
High kick. Busby's going to let it hit, and it will go to about the 2 or 3 yard line. Arkansas in the hole. Beautiful kick. They talk about Steve Little, but out in Oklahoma, they talk about Uba Von Schaumann, who just booted that one 54 yards and got a reverse spin on it.
And I think I saw Barry Switzer smile along the sideline. He hasn't had very many smiles tonight. That brought one to his face.
3:08 left in the half, and Arkansas is in the end zone. Oklahoma has had difficulty holding on to the football, but Arkansas has played great defense.
Lou Holtz has not been afraid to call a pass coming out of his end zone this year. He's the kind of coach that's not afraid to gamble a little bit. Let's see what he sent in from the sideline.
Now Cagney carries the football and picks up 3 yards out to the 6 yard line. It'll be second down and 7. George Cumby and Terry Peters made the tackle.
We talked about misdirection plays earlier. That's exactly what this is. Cal Cagney starts his backs both to the left, makes a quick step over there, and does a quick circle, firing back to this side. But great reaction on the part of this Oklahoma defense. Got him stopped after about a 3 yard gain.
Second down and 7. Roland Sales gets another good run and has a first down at the 20-yard line. Sales has been outstanding running from the fullback position. This time Steve Hine, the left tackle, sprung him over the left side. And Oklahoma, for the moment at least, lets Arkansas off the hook.
It's just a hard dive again. Sales gets out there. That's Kinlaw, who was blocked on the play. Does not get over to seal it from the inside. Sales breaking clean for the first down.
Sales is the answer of Arkansas to the fine running of Elvis Peacock. Peacock has over 80 yards. Sales has 59. Now Cagney misdirection again, but only gets a perhaps a yard. Dragged down by Kinlaw, who was not sealed off that time, at a second down 9.
Well, I'd say a great player can be beaten. Any player can be beaten, but most of them know how to come back, and Reggie Kinlaw comes back with a fury here, and he makes Cal Cagney pay for that little bit of embarrassment last time.
The speedy Bobby Duckworth comes in as a wide receiver and comes in with the play. So they have two wide receivers in there now, Robert Farrell and Bobby Duckworth. And Bruce Hayes. So they've got three in there now, but the ball goes straight ahead. And there is Trent Bryant, number 25. Reggie Kinlaw again in on the tackle. But Bryant picks up 5 yards, and it's third down and 5 to go.
And we've got a player. Looks like Steve Heim is bouncing around a little bit. They're going to have to help him off the field. Senior tackle's done a fine job in there for him. If he can't go back in, it looks like he's limping a bit. They'll miss his performance in there, Jim.
Wilbur was in there when Reggie Mathis beat him for a sack earlier. Well, we have our NBC TBS regional basketball starting on Sunday, January the 8th. A lot of games, you're looking at them. Minnesota, Michigan in an important Big Ten game. Mississippi State, Alabama. Colorado, Iowa State, UCLA, and aren't they doing well at Washington State? And speaking of doing well, Arkansas is undefeated. A great team. They'll play Houston, St. Bonaventure, and Virginia Tech, Holy Cross and Army. And coverage of all the games but the UCLA-Washington State game will start at 2 o'clock Eastern time. UCLA and Washington will go at 3 o'clock Pacific time. That was a great game that we saw, Notre Dame and Kentucky. Looked like Notre Dame was going to pull it off in the second half Saturday, but Kentucky held on at Louisville to win. Here's Arkansas. Cal Cagney has the play on third down 5, 1:34 to go. Ball at the 25-yard line. Duckworth and Farrell go left. Cal Cagney hands to Sales again, and Sales has got the first down. Roland Sales tripped up by Cumby as he went by. And they've been going off the right side of the Oklahoma defense.
They're going to the weak side of their offensive set. Bruce Tatum that time, the weak side end, or the drop end as they call him, fired in hard, stripped Cal Cagney to the ground. Unfortunately, Cal Cagney did not have the ball. Sales had it and did a fine job of running for that first down.
First down from the 31-yard line. Nearing halftime in our spectacular of lights. Now Cagney looking to throw, loops it out here. As a speedster there, that is Barnabas White. And White gets across the 35-yard line. For those of you who tune in and figure what happened, it's 14-0. A fumble at the 9 set up the first touchdown by Arkansas. Sales took it in from the 1. And later, they drove 57 yards, the Razorbacks did, with Cal Cagney taking it in from the 1. And Oklahoma has not come close. They've been inside the 30 one time, and that's it. Second down and short, about 3. Sales comes close to the first down and may have it at the 43-yard line with a half a minute to go. Actually, 34 seconds, and Arkansas is hungry. They call time with 34 seconds to go.
Well, I'll tell you, they've got the momentum here, Jim. They're moving the ball down the field. It's interesting to me that a team so powerful and so heavily favored in this game has not been able to slow them down any more than they have. And certainly the overpowering defense that had evidenced itself earlier on Oklahoma's part has not been out on this field the first half.
Well, as we look at Lou Holtz, you and I were impressed with the quality of coaching, not only by Lou Holtz and his staff, but by Barry Switzer and his staff.
Two very professional staff and two very... back and forth. It looks like in the early going, the adjustments have favored Arkansas. We'll see who comes out with the best adjustments at halftime, what happens early in the second half. But right now, there might be some more points on the board.
Roland Sales has carried 8 times for 71 yards. Ron Calcagni has rushed for 42 yards on 10 carries and is 3 for 5 throwing the ball for 40 more yards. This first half, whether you're a Sooner fan or a Razorback fan, goes thus far, and they've only got a half minute to go to the Razorbacks. They have outplayed the Sooners, who have hurt themselves by dropping the football. Now Cagney back, under pressure, gets the ball away and out of bounds. The man is trying to come back, but the ball is out of bounds, and the flag goes down at the 31-yard line.
I think he's going to get called for grounding the football. He
that's
sure
what
is.
It is.
Well, that is a judgment call, Jim, and I'm sure that Cal Cagney is saying, well, you got me, because that's what he did.
Cal Cagney, when I said a receiver was coming back, he only had to come back about 30 yards to try to catch that ball, and the officials saw the same thing.
that wasn't a likely choice, I guess.
A spectacular in light at halftime, and may I tell you that all of the 80,000, or at least most of the 80,000 here, have been armed with flashlights to help out with the lights that you will see on the field. Bruce Hay comes wide to the right. Robert Farrell goes to the left. It is second down, 25, and they're going to run this out as Sales carries the football out to the 35-yard line. And the clock continues to run. 17 seconds to go. And Reggie Mathis is slow in getting up. And now they stop the clock with 10 seconds left. And this is an official timeout as Mathis, holding onto that right hip, goes off. Arkansas's defense has already lost Howard Sampson. And now Mathis will be replaced by Doug Simchick, a senior.
Simchick's a good football player and has played a lot of football for them during the year, Jim. But they'll miss Mathis. He's certainly a quick and aggressive defensive end.
They've started the clock again, and I think we've seen the last play of a very unexpected first half. That's the end of the first half. Arkansas, with 2 first quarter touchdowns, leads the team that came in here thinking they could win the national championship by winning tonight.
Thank you.
switch from the old crooner to the king of rock and roll. Gentlemen, the University of Arkansas Marching Razorback Band. Ladies and gentlemen, under the direction of Mr. Gene Thrailkill, director of University Bands, and led onto the field by sophomore drum major David French, we proudly present the 1977-78 First Ride of Oklahoma! We'll be right back.
band takes this opportunity to feature Miss Pam Martin, whirling to the exciting mambo in the Broadway hit West Side Story. Time performance with Leonard Bernstein's moving ballad, Somewhere. Oklahoma!
And now stay tuned for the exciting 1978 Orange Bowl Spectacular of Lights, right after these messages from your local station.
Ladies and gentlemen, tonight, the Orange Bowl honors the most unique event staged in America in 1977. Disneyland and Walt Disney World's incredible spectacular of nighttime pageantry and imagination in electrical sights and sounds. The Main Street Electrical Parade.
Ladies and gentlemen, Alice in Wonderland. Ladies and gentlemen, from the new Walt Disney motion picture, Pete's Dragon, meet the stars. Elliot the Dragon and Sean Marshall.
Wow, Elliot. Look at all the people. Hi, everybody. Can you see them, Elliot? They can see you, too. Gee, it's sure not like back home in Passamaquoddy, is it? I've never seen this many people in my life. Look over there at all those lights. And you're shining pretty good yourself, Elliot. I knew you could breathe fire, but I didn't know you could do this. Hello over there. What's the matter? Never seen a dragon before? Come on, Elliot. Show them your stuff. Boy, what a way to start the new year. Out here in the middle of the Orange Bowl with all these people. Whoa. See, Elliot? I told you to have a great time.
Whoa!
Don't get too excited, Elliot. They tell me there's still a lot more that's going to happen here. Hey, Elliot, look at all those beautiful butterflies.
Whoa.
Now that's real magic.
Whoa.
Thank you.
too.
Watch this.
Ladies and gentlemen, the Orange Bowl 1978 Spectacular of Lights. The Orange Bowl Committee wishes to thank the Entertainment Division of Disneyland and Walt Disney World, NBC, and the spectators of today's game for the production of this halftime spectacular.
I don't know how they do it, but they do it every year, an outstanding halftime show. And by the way, Union Carbide donated 40,000 flashlights. The Boy Scouts of America for sale here tonight, and the proceeds of the flashlight sale all goes to various scouting organizations. An outstanding halftime, and it's been an outstanding and surprising first half. Arkansas leads Oklahoma 14-0. This 1978 Orange Bowl game is being brought to you by the developers of such tire innovators as the new all-season Tiempo Radio. By Light Beer, everything you always wanted in a beer and less. By Pontiac, 1978 is Pontiac's best year yet, so come in and price our Pontiacs. And by Texaco, who also brings you quality automotive products you can trust. I'm Jim Simpson with Merlin Olsen. It is 14-0 at halftime, and Merlin, I'm sure that around the country, the Arkansas Rooters are saying, hang in there, Razorbacks. And the Sooners are saying, what can we do to come back?
Jim, I think we laid it out pretty clearly at the top of the show when we said that this was a scrappy Arkansas defense. They'd made their living with the defensive part of it, with their special teams during the year. You can see by the statistics, things are not that far apart statistically. But the big numbers are in the turnovers, where Oklahoma has put it on the ground. Arkansas has pounced on it and then took quick advantage of those turnovers. They were also able to drive the ball early, and that was the key in the first quarter. But certainly Lou Holtz, you see him there, bringing his Arkansas Razorbacks onto the field, very excited about what they've done this first half.
And Oklahoma, of course, can they come back? Can they win? If they do, the Sooners could say on Tuesday, tomorrow, hey, we've got a shot at the national championship. But they've got to win tonight to lay claim to the national championship. I'm sure that Notre Dame, Texas, Penn State, and Alabama, and Arkansas all want a shot at that mythical championship.
Well, over on the other side of the field, Barry Switzer and his Sooners know that the wishbone is not a come-from-behind kind of defense. It's the kind of defense that you want to have control of a football game. If they get into trouble late in the ball game, they may well have to break the bone or go away from their bread and butter, which is the wishbone. Certainly, he's told them in the locker room, let's go out there, let's stop Arkansas in the first series, let's take the ball and drive down the field. I think we're going to see a whale of a third quarter here, and the third quarter, the first couple of series, may be the key to the ball game, Jim.
All of the scoring came in the first quarter of this ball game when Billy Sims fumbled at the 9 and later Sales took it in from the 1. You saw that on your screen. And then there was the bona fide drive, the only one by either team, 57 yards, with Ron Calcagni taking it over from the 1-yard line. And it is 14-0 Arkansas over highly favored Oklahoma. The newspapers this morning here in warm Miami described the Arkansas team as being 18-point underdogs. And Arkansas knew, and Oklahoma knew when it took the field, that Texas had been upset this afternoon and that the national championship is still up for grabs. Remember two things. Oklahoma can score a lot of points. It has done that, especially in the last four or five games. But also remember, the Arkansas defense has only allowed about 8.5 points per ball game. And what's more, in the last quarter, has outscored their opponents 102-16. It is not over yet, but Arkansas will get the football first.
Certainly one of the advantages for Oklahoma is that the field has dried out here, Jim. We had a brief shower about an hour and a half before game time. It's been very pleasant, very warm since that time. The field has dried out now, and you won't see the kind of slipping that we saw by the Oklahoma backs early in the game that did cost them some of their momentum.
Uwe von Schaumann will kick it off. And it will not be brought out. Barnabas White will keep the ball in the end zone, and Arkansas will set up first and 10 from their own 20-yard line. Ron Calcagni is the quarterback. Trent Bryant is one running back, 25. Roland Sales with a touchdown and an outstanding first half with more than 70 yards. 21 the fullback. Gary Stiggers, one flanker, has a hip pointer. They're concerned about him. Robert Farrell and Bruce Hay have been alternating with Bobby Duckworth bringing in plays. And Stephen Heim, the left tackle, is playing with a bruised knee. Calcagni is looking to throw on first down and has a man out there, and it is complete. Across the way, and that is
Stiggers.
Stiggers, the hip pointer man that they're so concerned about.
Well, they say he is just one tough kid. He broke his wrist the first day of training this year and actually didn't even miss a single day of practice. Came back and made the team with a broken wrist.
Stiggers filling in for Donnie Bobo, who had 5 touchdown catches plus 1 touchdown running. One of the suspended Arkansas players. First down, Calcagni carries for a couple of yards. And I'll repeat what Merlin, you said at the beginning of the game, that Lou Holtz said. He said, too much has been made of the players who are not here, and not enough has been made of the players who are here. Well, they're making their own headlines tonight thus far.
They certainly are, Jim, and I think the most surprising thing about the game so far is the very steady performance of this Arkansas offensive team.
Second down and 8 to go. Calcagni under pressure, running out, goes, and Bryant drops the ball at the 42-yard line. Would have been a first down. And Reggie Mathis, who limped off toward the end of the first half, was the man putting deep pressure on Ron Calcagni.
It looks like Reggie may have a hip pointer. Now, this is a most remarkable play. Calcagni is showing some of his magic, getting away. I don't think he has any idea of throwing to the right there. That ball is just deflected out of his hands and almost ended up being a reception to the back on the right. Here's another look at it. He's looking downfield. He wants to throw downfield. Ball bounced off onto the right, and Trent Jones almost had a chance to pick it up and carry it for a first down.
Third down and 8. Stiggers and Farrell come to the left, and Calcagni goes back to throw. Calcagni has a man out of the backfield. That is Sales again. First down, Roland Sales. We watched him in practice the other day work this play time and again.
Again, they're running the Oklahoma linebackers off deep and hitting a hot back out of the backfield. And I'll tell you, Sales did a great job of one-handing that ball and then just driving for that first down. He's had some kind of football game.
Ball is at the 48-yard line of Arkansas. The drive started on their own 20. Calcagni hands off, and straight ahead goes Roland Sales. And Reggie Mathis down at the bottom of that heap, getting up along with George Cumby. And the ball is marked in Oklahoma territory at the 48-yard line.
It was the Arkansas defense that came out and set the tempo in the very early part of this game, in that very first series. And now it's the offense, the Arkansas offense, who come out, and let's see if they can keep it up here in the second half.
Speaking of the Arkansas defense, Howard Sampson has a broken arm. He said, I'm all right, Mom, but his arm is broken. Second down and 6, Calcagni hands the ball off to Bryant. And Bryant gets near the first down inside the 45-yard line. Hold it, that is Barnabas White.
Let's look on the inside. Reggie Kinlaw is the guy you've got to control on the nose if you're going to get some yardage in there. He's slipping, and that's a fine job on the center there. Actually, I think Reggie Mathis is the man that slipped over from the backside to make the tackle, but not until they'd made excellent yardage.
That's the first down by Barnabas White, who is an excellent sprinter, got to the semifinals of the 60-yard indoors this year. Now, Cagney, I don't know if that's a busted play or not. He gets to the 40-yard line, a gain of a yard, and it'll be second down and nine.
I don't think it was busted. I think the Oklahoma defense just busted it up. Reggie Kinlaw is the kind of guy that was coming hard on the inside on that one. That was Rick Shoemaker, the center that I wanted to talk about a second ago, who's done an excellent job this whole game playing on a man that's much bigger physically than he is in Reggie Kinlaw.
Believe it or not, Arkansas right now is almost within field goal range of Steve Little. And the ball is on the 40-yard line. Misdirection play, pitch out to Sales. Sales turns the corner, first down to the 30-yard line. Roland Sales having an outstanding night. His best of the year was 71 yards, and he's done more than that tonight. Bruce Tate made the tackle across the way. And Lou Holtz brought a team in here that refused to quit. Time is running away. Oklahoma down by 14 with 26 minutes and 45 seconds to play. But Arkansas continues to control the football. First down from the 30. And dragged down immediately. Another fine defensive play. Simchik puts him down as a flag goes down. That was Barnabas White.
Simchik had gone in there for the injured Reggie Mathis. Reggie apparently having trouble with a hip, came hard from the backside and just blitzed the back. The penalty against Arkansas.
And it's a big one for holding. That'll set him back near midfield. Our referee again tonight, Pete Williams, with his crew from the Southeastern Conference and the Big Ten. And again, today in other bowls, Notre Dame defeated Texas 38-10, knocking off the number one team. Alabama roared over Ohio State. And in a real thriller in the Rose Bowl, Michigan fought back, but the 14-point underdog University of Washington in its first Rose Bowl in years and years and years. And with 40,000 people from the great Northwest down there to watch, Washington beat Michigan 27-20. Cumbie has gone out, and O.B. Moore has gone in at the strong side linebacker spot on first down and 25 from the 45. And this is Stiggers blocking on the far side. He's got speed. He breaks through everybody. Stiggers inside the 10. Bill Ray makes the stop of the freshman from Fort Worth, Texas, Gary Stiggers. A 39-yard run. And Arkansas continues to knock at the Sooner door.
We told you earlier that Arkansas had planned to use a lot of misdirection to take advantage of the great speed and reactions of Oklahoma. Here it's executed just absolutely to perfection. They got Bruce Tate, who's the backside guy, down. And here you see an excellent block. I believe that's Herman that's just driving over the top of his man. Stiggers did a great job of running with that ball. Almost lost it. Sucked it up. Great field position again.
First down from the 8. Hand off down to the 5-yard line, where Cumbie makes the stop of Roland Sales. Well, I keep thinking that there's a lot of time for Oklahoma to come back, but Arkansas has come out firing at the end of the half, and I keep remembering that in Barry Switzer's outstanding career, superior career at Oklahoma, he's only lost but 4 ball games, 151. And it's his alma mater that's causing him to sweat tonight. He went to Arkansas and captained them to a bowl victory. Cal Cagney pitches back to Sales. Sales inside the 5 and down to about the 3. And it'll be third down and goal to go from the 3. Richard Murray came over along with Darrell Hunt. And there is Thomas Lott on the sideline. He would love to be able to get back in the ball game and have the football for Oklahoma. Sales is now carried for 96 yards. That's 25 yards better than he's done all year long in any single game.
Well, Arkansas simply hasn't let Thomas Lott do his part of the magic out there. They've done a great job of controlling the momentum of this game, and they've sure got it in their hands right now if they can get it into the end zone.
But back to Barnabas White and Roland Sales, and Cal Cagney comes to the line of scrimmage and says, hold everything. I want to call timeout.
I believe it's Oklahoma called timeout. I don't know what they saw that they didn't like, Jim, but they must have been, well, and Darrell Hunt down there awfully upset. I don't blame them. They're, They're getting booted around pretty good down there. And that's a proud defensive team, too, and a well-coached defensive team.
Well, we have to go back to the fact that not only are the Arkansas players playing well, but the fact that the former Nebraska defensive coach for so many years is now the coach of Arkansas. And he has defensed Oklahoma so far nearly perfectly. The man has been able to slip away on occasion has been Elvis Peacock.
Well, Monty Kiffin has certainly done a great job. He and Larry Lacewell, who's the defensive coach for Oklahoma, are very close friends. They talk nearly every other day or sometimes every day during the season. Toward the end of the year, after the bowl pairings were announced, Barry Switzer said, look, Larry, I don't think we better have too many of those conversations with your friend Monty up there. But I would definitely say that it's been Kiffin's ability to position his people and then the execution of the Arkansas defense that made it very tough on Oklahoma to run that wishbone out there tonight.
Third down, and let's call it from the 2-yard line. Now Cagney still on his feet and gets the ball out of the end zone and sends it in the end zone for Stiggers. And it's fourth down. And will they go to Steve Little or will they go all the way?
He's fouled
the flag down, and it might be a second intentional grounding, and Cal Cagney does not like this one.
Well, I don't blame him for not liking that one. There was a receiver in the area, and it was close enough that it's a very tough judgment call by the official.
That will give them a fourth down and long because they lose the down. That's the signal they gave you right there. And here comes Steve Little.
We'll give you another look at it. Cal Cagney does a great job of getting away. It looked to me like his knee was down before the pass, but there's Stiggers. The pass was almost on target, but the official determined that it was being thrown away deliberately, calling for the penalty.
From 32 yards out, Little has plenty of foot for this one. The question is it accurate enough? 32 yards away, it is good. A 32-yard field goal by Steve Little. 9:32 to go, third quarter. Arkansas 17, Oklahoma nothing. I'm Jim Simpson with Merlin Olson. Lou Holtz is arguing with the officials because Steve Little likes to use an older football. And Holtz is saying, we're not getting the older football for him to kick. Well, that was academic on that last kick because Little put it through 32 yards and it was still going.
I'd have to say, I have never seen a kicker with such a live leg. He kicks it so high, it goes over the protective net at the end of the field, and he does it just like a machine. He just pops it out of there like one of those kicking machines. Unbelievable kicker.
First time Oklahoma will get its hands on the football and miss the second half. Arkansas had the ball for 5.5 minutes. And now Little has not had one return today. Let's watch this kickoff. And there's another boomer. That may be a field goal from the kickoff. Can you believe it? We've got to talk about it. Now, when he does go professional, which he wants to do, he will not have the kicking tee.
It will make a difference because certainly having it propped up that way does give him a better shot and a better angle at it. But he gets such tremendous height on the ball. I said I've never seen a kicker get the ball so high. I don't think he'll have any trouble adjusting to professional football.
Now the Oklahoma fans are settling down and say, this is the time that we get started.
I don't think we'll give him an old ball to kick, though.
This is Billy Sims, outstanding speed, being run down from behind by Dan Hampton. Sims is caught by a tackle. And this is part of what Arkansas wants to do. They want to force Oklahoma, if they can, to go to the short side of the field.
One of the things that Oklahoma feared was the team defensive speed of Arkansas. And here you see him pursuing great lateral pursuit to the outside. And I'll tell you, if you can get him running sideways and pursue with that kind of speed, they aren't going to make many yards on you.
Loss of yards, second down, 11. Barry Switzer having some anxious moments. And that is Kenny King breaking the tackle, first down across the 35. The last time King had that kind of run, he fumbled the football. But now he moves the ball out, first down for Oklahoma.
Here's another shot of it. First man through. Lott reads the man on the outside, hands off to King, and King just powers his way right through the middle of all that traffic. You'd wonder how he could ever get through there, but he's got great ability to cut and to run. He gets down there to the 35-yard line.
Fine tackle by Vaughn Lusby. First down, Lott with the football, and down he goes. Lott rolled his fullback into the line and then was written down by Reggie Freeman.
Jerry Saxon had covered Bill Sims on the outside. He was the toss man, and Freeman had Lott covered. There was just no chance for him after he passed that initial fullback going into the line.
Second down and 12 to go. Oklahoma trying to get itself untracked. They've been inside the Arkansas 30 only once. Both Rhodes and Kimball are now in here on a long yardage situation. Lott rolling out, and down he goes, slipping. And right there to contain him was Jim Howard, had he been able to maintain his footing. Now, Merlin, I'm sure around the country, and Sooner country and Razorback country, they're asking themselves, how can an Arkansas defense contain such a high-powered offense as Oklahoma, admitting that Arkansas has played tough defense all year?
Well, I think it's a combination of two things, Jim. Good quickness and good defensive construction. They've got an excellent game plan, and it's working well. They're fixing their defenses in there. They're forcing Lott to make choices he doesn't like. And then Oklahoma has had trouble with their own wishbone. They're not running it as well as they did late in the year.
Third down, Lott forced to throw, goes long. Everybody's double-teamed, and it's thrown over everybody with Bobby Kimball, the nearest Sooner in the territory. And again, Oklahoma will kick the ball away with fourth down and more than 10 yards to go. In the first 7 minutes and 59 seconds of the third quarter, the Razorbacks have played just like they did in the first half.
And the Razorback fans in this stadium come alive. On the other side of the field, Barry Switzer is saying, all right, guys, we're a strong team, we're a powerful team, a proud team, we don't quit. Let's go out there and play some football.
Aye. Von Schaumann is a tremendous kicker, and that is Lusby back inside his 20-yard line. And it'll be first down and 10, and Arkansas's got the football again after that 48-yard punt. 6:53 to go. We're in the third quarter. Arkansas 17, Oklahoma nothing. Joe, the premiere is on Sunday the 22nd. It's quite a show. Calcagni goes back on first down. It's open to him on the right side, and he carries for just perhaps a yard. Back to the 19-yard line as Reggie Kinlaw, the All-American, was there to force him out of bounds. For a moment, it looked like that Calcagni had a lot of room in which to run, but Kinlaw closed him down in a hurry. It'll be second down and 9 as the clock continues to run. And you begin to haul out the cliches you always do in situations like this, and one of the ones that we keep thinking of, and I'm sure Oklahoma's thinking of, you can't score unless you got the football.
They got to be thinking turnover right here.
Now Cagney carrying the football, and again for short yardage. Out to the 24-yard line, and it'll be third down and 4. And another All-American, this one George Cumbie, just getting up in your picture there. He was a fullback last year, turned linebacker, and immediately made All-American. He and Darrell Hunter are All-Americans, and so is Reggie Kinlaw in the middle, and so is Zach Henderson. A fine free safety.
And that makes the performance of this Arkansas offense even that more incredible because of the talent of this Oklahoma team.
Look at this. The blitz was on, and there's a first down on the flip. Reading it perfectly, Calcagni got the ball to Roland Sales, and picks up the first down. Everybody was coming on third down, and that means that Arkansas, on 8 third downs, have made first downs on 6 of their 8 tries. What a contrast to Oklahoma, which is 1 of 8.
And you've got to wonder if Calcagni didn't read that blitz coming. He was so cool and had the perfect play called for it. Little flare pattern to the outside, dropped quickly, got the ball off quickly. Excellent call, excellent reception. Good first down.
There goes Fred Bryant. Look out! Into the secondary. And across the 45, where Terry Peters made a saving tackle. And it's first down, Arkansas.
Here's a closer look at it from the end zone. They make their living, they said, on the hard dive, and there you see it. They're stretching everyone out with the possibility of the option, and then able to hold down that nose man enough to pop Trent, to prop the halfback through on the inside. Trent Bryant doing a great job of running that ball for a first down.
First down, Calcagni hands the ball off, and there goes that man again, Roland Sales, who is just rolling up more and more yardage. Sales having an outstanding night. Thus far, he has gained 108 yards. And the ball is on the 42-yard line. 5.5 minutes to go. Arkansas up by 17. Stiggers comes to the left. There goes the man again. Sails. He makes the play. 10-5. First and goal to go. From the 3-yard line, Roland Sails and Richard Turner made a saving tackle. Incredible. Can you imagine number one Texas being beaten and now number two Oklahoma in this kind of game?
Not only beaten, but Arkansas is making it look easy as Roland Sails pops through. Not only gets in there for long yardage, but breaks through a pair of tackles there all the way down to about the 4-yard line before they finally pin him.
Ball just inside the 4-yard line. Arkansas, the 18-point underdogs. Oklahoma saying that they will certainly win the national championship next year, and they hope they would tonight. But things aren't going that way. There it is! Touchdown, and there's that man again, Sails. Oh, my!
And there's a very happy coach on the sideline.
150 yards to Sails.
Let's give some credit to Greg Colinda and Mark Lewis over there on that right side. They opened a beautiful hole for Sails. Popped through clean, did a little extra on his own, in for the TD.
Well, they were concerned when Ben Cowens was suspended with 1,235 yards. But Sails has more than taken up the slack. He's got 150 tonight. Steve Little is in and adds the extra point. And would you believe it? Number two ranked Oklahoma, the 18-point favorite, with 4:40 to go third quarter, trails 24-0. The dynamic duos coming up starting on the 22nd of January at 2 o'clock before Sports World. Eight teams of famous athletes competing, such as Jim Brown and Jim Taylor and Arnold Palmer and Raymond Floyd and Tom Seaver and Johnny Bench. But what I want to hear is John Brody do bowling.
he's
the MC for that one.
I bet he could do it. He did a great job along with Kurt on the Rose Bowl today.
You know, I'm just thinking Alabama's sitting there thinking maybe we'll be the national champions. Penn State is hoping so. Texas beat today, hope so. Notre Dame, which beats Texas, hope so. If this score holds up, Arkansas is going to hold up its hand and say, hey, folks, what about us? They would be 11-1 and would have knocked off the number two team.
And you talk about next year. They only lose five members of this team next year. They're talking about next year, too.
Look at Little kickoff again. Again, it is a hopeless case out of the end zone. Tremendous display by Steve Little.
Oklahoma has so much respect for Little. Well, there you see Sales and Cal Cagney. That's a dynamic duo on the sideline there, Jeff. I started to say that Oklahoma had so much respect for Little that they didn't even practice kickoff returns this week.
By the way, people are probably wondering, Roland Sails with 150 yards and two touchdowns tonight. It's a second year man. He's got two more years to go with the Razorbacks. Thomas Lott. And there's a pass to Bobby Kimball. Lost the football. Belongs to Arkansas. They fumbled it away again. And William Hampton comes up with it. And Barry Switzer is beside himself. What to do? That's another fumble. Sims has fumbled it away. King has fumbled it away. Peacock fumbled, but it was recovered by Oklahoma. And now Bobby Kimball with a big gain fumbles it away, and it's Arkansas ball at the 38.
Well, sometimes it just won't quit, and when it starts to go bad, it really turns upside down. And Oklahoma's a fine football team. They're sure having their trouble out there tonight, Jim.
Now Cagney hands the sail. The Orange Bowl rushing record is 187 yards by Larry Smith of Florida, one of your old teammates in 1967. This young man here could break it.
Well, the way he's going right now, he's going to break it.
Ball is at the 31-yard line. 4:12 to go, third quarter. Oklahoma for the national championship they thought up for grabs for themselves if they beat Arkansas tonight. Finds they've got to score more than 24 points to do it. And they've got 19 minutes in which to do it, and they have not got the football. Now Cagney misdirection again. Looking over the middle. Pass intercepted. Oklahoma stopped it.
Darryl
and that
Ray.
Is Darryl Ray.
Boy, what a great interception. You've got to come up with the big plays when you need them. Good shot. Good shot of Stiggers breaking down the sideline. Watch the reaction to Darrell Ray right across. Perfect timing. Stretches out, snaps up that football. That's a big play, Jim.
Big play. They've got the ball at the 5.5-yard line. Ray earlier in the half, first half, made a great saving tackle on the far sidelines. And now comes up with a big interception. Oklahoma still alive. Elvis Peacock. Peacock is out to the 20-yard line. First down, Oklahoma. Well, I'll tell you one thing. Everybody knows that if Oklahoma gets that running game going, this ball game is far from over.
Far from over, Jim. But the wishbone is a tough offense to come from behind with, because you need time. It's basically structured for the run and the short controlled pass. And Barry Switzer is going to have to make some decisions pretty soon about how he's going to get those points on the board. If he can get down and get this one in, he may have time to do it with the wishbone.
Second man through is Sims, and Sims gets a couple of yards.
I'll tell you this, the Arkansas team has got other ideas for him.
There's Larry Jackson getting up, the fine junior linebacker out of Hot Springs, the leading tackler on the team. And now limping off is Jimmy Walker, and that's a man they can ill afford to lose, holding that left leg high. Injuries have hit the defense of Arkansas, costing them Howard Sampson to a broken arm, and now Jimmy Walker goes off holding his left leg high.
They certainly don't want to lose Walker. That Sims that's on the ground for Oklahoma, that would be a heavy loss on both sides. But Walker, the number one down lineman for Arkansas, he has had a marvelous night. He's been all over the field and clamping things down, doing a beautiful job.
Larry Jackson getting instructions, and they're still working over Billy Sims, who now pops to his feet and begins to walk off the field, limping as he goes away.
But going off under his own power. And they're looking very closely at Walker's leg on the bench. We certainly hope that he is not hurt severely.
Donnie Phillips, a freshman from Hermitage, Arkansas, comes in and will anchor that left tackle spot. Second down, 8 to go. Let's see if they go right at it. Lott instead throws to Rose. Rose has got the football and dragged down at the 40-yard line. First down for Oklahoma. Les King brings him down at the 40.
Rhodes did a fine job of slipping around the coverage. Worked around the defensive back, Brad Schaap. And Lott just stepped out of there, faked the first option, and zipped in the ball cleanly. Excellent pass, good reception. They've got it down to the 40. Let's see if they can take the rest of the way in.
Arkansas leading 24 to nothing, 2.5 minutes left, third quarter. First down at the 40-yard line. Flag goes down.
A whole bunch of flags are down.
Look at this. Look at this. Oklahoma has not gone scoreless in the last 130 games. I'm not sure that they will tonight,
wow,
by any stretch of the imagination. But that's a long time, and they've been shut up for almost three quarters, and here comes a big penalty against them. 5 yards.
Now, the Oklahoma coaches will tell you that their problems early in the year, as we've mentioned before, came from two sources, from their inability to hang on to the football and from penalties. And that's been the case tonight, hasn't it, Jim?
That's right. They struggled by Vanderbilt 25-23, dropping the ball, and they had Ohio State something like 20 to nothing and won it by a point when they began to drop the football. First down and 15 to go now. Lott goes down. Reggie Freeman. An outstanding job done tonight by Reggie Freeman. When you began to compare personnel, no one in Miami was comparing Reggie Freeman with Reggie Kinlaw. They both play the same position.
Well, except that Monty Kiffin has switched the positions around a little. If he put Reggie Freeman on the outside and said, look, we don't expect you to get in and go nose-to-nose on Tabor. He's bigger and stronger than you are. We'll push you out where you can do a job for us. He has done that most effectively here tonight.
Second down and 20 from the 30-yard line after that 5-yard loss. And Lott is forced to pass, setting up the screen to Peacock on the far sideline, and he drops himself down at the 24-yard line. That is another loss of 5 yards. Oklahoma's going backwards.
Freeman coming off his nose position, actually on the outside that time on Greg Roberts, but it is a screen pass. Lott says, hey, I got rid of the ball, Reggie. Let me go.
Third down and 26 to go for Oklahoma. Who must have thought after intercepting and stopping Arkansas that the momentum might turn around. Lott forced the pass. Having trouble. Running out. Good on his feet. And down he goes out of bounds. Way short of the first down. It'll be fourth down and 12 or 13 to go.
Well, it looks like we got a roughness foul over on the side. Brad Schaap involved in a little skirmish over there with one of the Oklahoma players after the play was over. Let's see who they're going to lay it on.
If it's against Arkansas, of course, it can really pick up Oklahoma.
15 yards.
First down. Well, Pete Williams will tell us.
It's
against Arkansas. Yeah. That's a big one.
It is, and it's a 15-yarder, and that's the kind of mistake that you don't want to make. When you got somebody with a fourth down play, you don't want to give them a first down. Lou Holtz down on that sideline kicking up a bunch of turfs of grass. He said, hey, that's dumb. We don't want to be dumb.
Penalty stepped off. Earlier, Arkansas made the same kind of mistake. Not as flagrant, but the result was the same. They were offside on a punt, which gave Oklahoma a first down. Jimmy Walker comes back into the game.
Well, that's good news. There's two tight ends in the game, too.
And yeah. Dean Blevins comes in. And Blevins is a thrower, a senior out of Norman. Two tight ends, Hicks and Valora. Oklahoma, with 55 seconds to go in the third quarter, tries to get on the board. There he goes, down to Peacock. First down inside the 35-yard line. Hicks with a crushing block to spring him.
We'll give you a better look at it from the end zone. Watch the fake to the first back, Kenny King. The handoff to the second back, Elvis Peacock. And Peacock just makes it work. Breaks hard to the outside. Excellent blocking downfield by David Overstreet, number 22. And Peacock fighting as hard as he can. He's picked up 114 yards tonight at 12 carries.
Blevins to Rose at the 20, the 19-yard line. First down, Oklahoma. They'll move the sticks. 29 seconds to go, third quarter. And getting up very slowly is the good fullback, Kenny King. A speedster. Back there to block for Dean Blevins.
That was the same pass that they'd thrown earlier to Rhodes. He just slipped in behind Les King, made the reception. Fine play.
David Overstreet inside the 10. First down, Oklahoma. First and goal to go.
David Overstreet showing the kind of skills he has as a runner. Again, he's the second back through. He gets off a very hard, determined shot at him by Dan Hampton, and he just flat runs over some people in there, gets all the way down the 8-yard line before the quarter ends on it.
Well, it'll be a wild and woolly fourth quarter, I am sure. We've gone through three quarters of play. Oklahoma threatens the trails 24 to nothing. We begin the fourth quarter. Oklahoma first down and goal to go from the 8-yard line. Dean Blevins is the quarterback. Levin looking to the end zone. Touchdown, that's Victor Hicks, the tight end. And that's only the second time all year long that Arkansas has been scored on by a touchdown pass. Only once before that pass.
That's five TD passes for Levin during the year. He threw that one to Dip Hicks, who ran just a little down and out pattern. Levin's getting out to the outside, buying some time. Excellent catch by Hicks. Breaks it out of bounds, right over the edge of the goal line, touchdown.
Well, Oklahoma's now scored in 131 consecutive games, which adds to their own NCAA record. And Arkansas, by contrast, must be saying, why a roughness penalty on fourth down and 15 to go? Time is called.
It looked like Arkansas didn't expect that Oklahoma would be going for two. And they came out lined up in it, and they, wait, hold up.
There is Lou Holtz. We've been publicizing the fact because Lou Holtz has been saying that the hardware microphone,
it
does have
it. It takes longer than that to say X post or something. I would say they would run the inside belly. What I would say, and I would say this. I'd bring a ball for bringing a strong safety or bringing somebody hard off the corner in case they're trying to roll back or something, but whatever you think.
All right, you've heard the words of Lou Holtz, who's been wearing a microphone throughout this game. He agreed to do it. I don't think Lou even knows he has it on now.
I'm sure he doesn't, Jim. That was Monty Kiffin who sent Brad Schaub back in there, and what Lou wanted to do was bring the strong safety off the corner. So you'll see the safety, one of the safeties, coming hard on a blitz. Let's see, there's Schaub coming up tight. You may see him coming hard.
It is 24-6 at the moment. Oklahoma's going for two. Peacock back. Peacock running. Peacock does not make it. Elvis Peacock is stopped short. And the score remains 24-6. We still have 14 minutes and 54 seconds to go. Arkansas leading. Looking up at our blink, that has given us all those good aerial shots tonight of the Orange Bowl, which is sold out. Lots of folks here. Spectacular light show at halftime, and thus far a very surprising game. Oklahoma trailing and about to kick off to Gary Stiggers and Barnabas White. Von Schaumann will kick it off, and he gets a good foot into the ball. And Stiggers is going to keep it in the end zone, and Arkansas will start first down at their own 20-yard line. They'll remain in the ball game 14 minutes and 54 seconds. Let's pause briefly for station identification. This is the NBC television network. He kind of muscled her out of there, didn't he?
He must have known he was on camera. Look at him. That's
somebody muscled him out, I think. All I want for Christmas is my two front feet.
My kids are here at the game. I'm sure they love that halftime pageantry, Jim. I can't wait to ask them about it.
Barnabas White with the football. He's got great speed, but down he goes in the backfield. Outstanding play by the Oklahoma defense. That's George Cumbie.
Oh, Kimba.
Cumbie coming over from his strong side linebacker position. Drops White for a 2-yard loss. Second down and 12.
Of course, right now, Barry Switzer on the sideline saying, let's go, defense. Get that ball back for us. We got to get another one on the board quick.
Hay and Stiggers are to the left. And there's Walden Sales, and he did not get very far this time. And that's George Cumbie a second time to make the stop. Two individually fine plays by George Cumbie.
Two great plays by the linebacker. And you can see the quickness. We said he had 4-4 speed. Certainly has to be the fastest linebacker I've ever seen or heard of. Probably if he makes it into professional football, no reason to say that he wouldn't, will end up playing somewhere in the defensive backfield.
He's got a couple of years to go, though, with Oklahoma. He's
a
sophomore.
The big year.
A fake to Roland Sales. They set it up on the far side to him. Sales gets out across the 30. First down, he's done it again. Big play for Roland Sales. A fake to him, and then the little lofted screen pass to Sales, who picks up the first down at the 35-yard line. The weather here in Miami, it did rain before the game. As Roland said, a little problem on the field now. And I said, as we came on the air, that the temperature was expected to dip into the 50s, and quickly an official of Miami called and said, but it's only 60 now. Yeah. It's a nice night.
It's a beautiful night for football, Jim.
Straight ahead goes Barnabas White. White has such speed that they like to use him a little like Kenny King of Oklahoma. Sent him on a dive play in the middle, hoping he just gets one step past that line of scrimmage, and then he is gone. Guess who made the tackle that time of Barnabas White? You're right, George Cumbie.
Again.
Lou Holtz along the sidelines. We've had the microphone on him throughout the game. We had some technical problems early, but you heard him set up that defense on the two-point play, and maybe we'll hear from him again. Second down and 8. Now Cagney pitches at the last minute, and down goes Barnabas White. Another loss. And guess who's there? Number 28. You'll see him get up in a second. I hate to say it, but it's George Cumbie again.
Man, we're talking about right in the middle, 28. Reggie Kinlaw does the first job. He gets a hold of Cal Cagney. And then you see that great speed as Cumbie just comes from the outside. Richard Murray coming over to finish the job. That's super football.
Richard Turner now comes up in at the nose guard, and Reggie Kinlaw goes out for the moment. It is third down and nine to go. Oklahoma wants the football back. Now Cagney being rushed, can't get it away, still on his feet, and it's going to be a big loss. Back to the five. Bruce Payton and Reggie Mathis, the end. And Arkansas under pressure. And Oklahoma with 11:50 to go, and down by 18.
Payton coming hard on the blitz, just blindsided Cal Cagney. He has no chance to get away. That's Reggie Mathis right there. Payton coming from the other side. Breaks him out. Cal Cagney fighting to keep his feet. He keeps drifting back toward his own goal line before Tate finally buries it.
High pass, Little gets the ball away, bounding up at the 30-yard line, and Oklahoma is going to have outstanding field position. Some may wonder why Cal Cagney didn't throw. Twice he's been called for intentionally grounding the ball, and I'm sure that was in his mind. A 24-yard punt, and it's 24-6, Arkansas. Sports World on the 22nd. Oklahoma at the 31-yard line. Lott is in there. Second man through. Overstreet gets down to the 22-yard line. Now here's the score. Arkansas 24 and Oklahoma 6. Oklahoma favored by 18. On the other hand, Arkansas over the year has allowed only 16 points in the fourth quarter while scoring 102. They are very proud of their fourth quarter prowess. But I guarantee you Oklahoma will test them before this night is over.
Well, Oklahoma is showing you a lot of character right now, putting that score on the board and then coming back with some great defensive play, getting a 24-yard punt, and now they're after another touchdown.
Second down two, and now it is a first down as Kenny King goes straight ahead and has the first down inside the 20-yard line. First down for Oklahoma. They are down by 18 with 10:35 to go. That's Steve Rhodes, who came in and whispered to Lott what play to use, and now Rhodes comes wide left.
Galen Hall calls those plays from upstairs.
Lott carries the football inside the 15 and down near the 10-yard line. He's got to get the ball to the 9.5 for the first down.
Give you a look at this from the ground. Lott making it into the stomach of Kenny King, breaking outside again, seeing that quick opening. And again, he's having trouble with his footing. He's had real problems along that right sideline all night long.
Second down and short, about three to go. Second man through is stood straight up by Reggie Freeman. Lott faked it, kept it, and was stood up and then pushed down by Freeman. And that is not a first down. It is third and short. They're in a situation where they've got two downs to make the first.
This is four down territory, definitely. They're not about to give it up down in there.
Third down, about a yard to go. Lott has wrestled down again. And look who did it again, Reggie Freeman, as George Cumbie did on the last series of downs. So Reggie Freeman has pulled off a couple of plays here, and it's fourth down, and that was a loss. Fourth down at about two.
Well, that's great defense. They just swarmed over the right side of that Oklahoma line and just stuck everybody. Lott didn't have any options. They were all stacked up.
Fourth down and two. This is Peacock. Look out! He's down. They held. Jim Howard, the defensive tackle. Arkansas comes off with help from Mike Massey.
You don't need play.
Well, if this holds up, the odds makers of America, who figured the Rose Bowl, who figured the Cotton Bowl and the Orange Bowl, might say, well, back to the old drawing board. 8:50 to go now. Time running out. Arkansas's got the football in the big lead. Arkansas 24, Oklahoma 6. 11 years ago, here in the Orange Bowl, it was Florida against Georgia Tech, and there goes Larry Smith of Florida, number 33. He outdistanced everybody, and you got it. That's the longest run from scrimmage, Smith goes all the way, 94 yards. That is an Orange Bowl record. And speaking of Orange Bowl records, Roland Sales is just 19 yards short of Larry Smith's Orange Bowl record for total rushing. First down 10, Arkansas. Straight ahead goes the quarterback, Ron Calcagni, the junior. He has got another year, and Reggie Kinlaw made the tackle. 8:38 to go. This has been an outstanding story. No matter what happens, Oklahoma with a chance for the national championship, being beaten 24-6. Arkansas 18-point underdogs. Arkansas with three players suspended. And look at the score. You heard right, 24-6. Second down and 7. And there are Sales again, finding it rough going there. Absolutely rough going. Dave Hutchins was up top. George Cumbie is in there, along with Bruce Tatum. Well, everybody had a shot at Sales that time, but he managed to pick up a yard or two. It'll be third down and 6 to go, and we have less than 8 minutes to go in the game.
Let's keep an eye on what Holtz has got here. It's a quick kick. Look at this, a quick kick.
Ball is bounding inside the 20-yard line, inside the 20, and will be picked up there and wrestled down. Henderson picks it up and is actually thrown back. A 63-yard quick kick by Steve Little, who sneaked into the backfield, and the Sooners didn't see him. Lou Holtz has given it all. 7:33 to go. And it belongs to the Sooners, but well back in their own territory.
That's a long ways from their own 22-yard line all the way to the other end.
Our blimp again gives you an idea of what an incredible sight it is here. And, of course, we're looking ahead now to basketball, which begins next Sunday. But we're also looking ahead to the next 7 minutes and 33 seconds of football here on NBC. As Dean Blevin comes out as the quarterback. First down from the 19-yard line. King in motion, and Blevin drops back to throw. Throws it out here and overthrows Elvis Peacock. Right on him was Jerry Saxton, the right end, who dropped off.
Well, people who watch Oklahoma will tell you that you've got to keep an eye on them to see when they're going to break the bone if they get behind. And they just did it, putting a man in motion and going to a drop back pass. Maybe they've decided that now is the time with 7:29. They've got to get a little desperate here and get some more points on the board.
Arkansas thought they had a chance in this ball game by playing great defense and with the kicking of Steve Little. But no one mentioned to us that Roland Sales would gain about 160 yards plus, and that Arkansas would be able to move the ball very well on the Sooners. Second down and 10. Blevins carries the football, and down he goes, and Dan Hampton has him, number 86, a junior out of Jacksonville, Arkansas. And it's another loss. And Oklahoma has spent much of its time tonight getting up, realizing they've got third and more than 10 yards to go.
Well, we talked earlier about the team speed of this Arkansas defense, and they demonstrated it again. That was one of the biggest, in fact, probably the biggest player on this team, who got out to the outside and simply just stripped him to the ground. Excellent play by Dan Hampton.
If Barry Switzer does lose tonight for the Sooners, it'll be only his fifth loss as head coach. Blevins pitches out to Peacock. Peacock with a blocker in front of him. Peacock still on his feet and battles for the first down across the 30-yard line. Overstreet was the man in front of him helping to clear the way. And Elvis Peacock is having an outstanding night in his final game for the Oklahoma Sooners and playing before his hometown crowd here in Miami.
He's one of the few that got away, Jim, and they would love to have had him here at the University of Miami. But he's been a great back for Oklahoma, very unselfish back, and has had a fine night here tonight in spite of the score on the board.
Peacock now with 116 yards, and more importantly for the Sooners, though, they've only got 6 minutes and 18 seconds left in this game. Time is slipping away. King goes in motion. Levins drops back. Flags are down. He throws, and it's off the hands and then intercepted, incomplete. King can't hold on to it, but flags went down immediately before Levins even got the pass away.
Receiver just slipped on that pattern. Steve Rhodes going down the field here. Watch him as he makes a little cut right there. Foot goes out from underneath him. And it's Les King, number 30, finally has a shot at it. Big cut on it, but he buried it in the ground. What's the penalty out there, Jim? Have you been keeping an eye on that?
Yep, it's for motion. And the debate is whether they make it first and 15 or second and 10 since the pass was no good. And they're going to drop it over to second and 10 and refuse that penalty. In all honesty now, for Oklahoma fans, it looks bleak with 6 minutes to go and 18 points down. And for Arkansas fans, don't go suey pig yet, but get them ready because it looks like the big one. King in motion. Levin's back. Peacock looking to throw for Lodge, and it's up for grabs and incomplete at the 39-yard line. Oklahoma, which does not like to throw the ball, has been forced to use Dean Blevins, who can throw the ball, and even their halfback, Elvis Peacock.
Well, we watched them practice this play in practice. You see Rhodes again, who is their best downfield receiver, but it doesn't look like Lusby was fooled at all. Brad Schaap, number 40, coming over, actually had a shot at intercepting that ball, but I'm afraid that's not going to get it for him. They're going to have to find something else to pick up that first down.
Third down and 10 yards to go. And if Oklahoma has a chance, that chance has to be kept alive with a first down play here. Levin goes, and again, Rhodes slips at the 50-yard line, and the ball is thrown well past him, and it is fourth down 10. And onto the field comes Von Schaumann.
Here's a good shot of Rhodes down the sideline again. That's the same sideline where we've had trouble earlier with the footing. You can see him trying to drive back to the outside, but the ball was poorly thrown behind him to the outside. He just simply could not plant and come around on it.
Nobody is deep for Arkansas. They're not quite sure that Oklahoma indeed is going to kick it away, but they are. And they'll just let this hit. Nobody wants to touch it. And Oklahoma will down it at the 30-yard line. And Arkansas, with 5:46 to go and with a big 18-point lead, has the football again and an outstanding upset probability. Jim Simpson with Merlin Olsen. There is Lou Holtz.
We're going to do it, Coach.
That's Monty Kiffin that he's talking to right there.
We're going to do it. Let me tell you, sales needs 20 yards to break the all-time Orange Bowl record.
They're advising him that Roland Sales needs 20 yards to break that record.
Sales needs 20 yards to break the all-time Orange Bowl rushing record. Tell him to suck it up, but hang on that ball. left 72. Okay.
Houston, well, Nutt goes in at quarterback.
And you heard the instructions right there. That's an unselfish coach, the man who will allow one of his players who's close to a record to have a shot at it. I hardly agree with that, Jim.
I would assume that Houston Nutt's going to give the ball to Roland Sale.
You better believe it.
There he goes. He got about four of those yards that he needed. Well, again, Texas was beaten this afternoon by Notre Dame, a lopsided score in the Cotton Bowl. That gave, of course, Michigan a chance to try to climb up in the standings and perhaps claim number one. But Washington took care of Michigan. Oklahoma realized that by winning tonight, it might stake a claim to the national championship, but they are losing with 5:15 to go and losing by 18 points. Alabama, Penn State, Texas, and Notre Dame, and Arkansas all might claim part of that national title. Sales gets the ball again, and it's going to be third down and short. They want him to get the record, and I think they must feel they're pretty secure with 18 points lead at less than 5 minutes to go.
And again, I think the real story, though, is that most people had counted Arkansas out of this game after the suspension of their three offensive players, the loss of Leotis Harris, their main weapon in the offensive line. They have proved themselves to be a very capable group of young men with a lot of heart and a lot of dedication, and also expertly coached offensively and defensively in this ballgame.
That hands the ball, and straight ahead goes Barnabas White, and he may have that first down. Kinlaw tripped him up. All depends on where they spot the football, whether or not he's got the first down. That's a big first down for Arkansas.
I know we said it earlier, but Lou Holtz has been calling the plays offensively, and just watching the way he's mixed his plays, the way he's calling from the sideline, he's done a marvelous job of keeping the Oklahoma defense off balance.
Arkansas at one time wasn't even on what they called the boards, and as of this morning, the newspaper said they were 18-point underdogs. They have a lead of 18 points, and flags go down. Now that's a 36-point differential in somebody's thinking. And it has been Arkansas all the way. They scored 14 points in the first quarter, but Oklahoma ran up against their old problem of fumbling the ball. Billy Sims' fumble on the nine gave Arkansas excellent field position. They took advantage of it, and Sale scored the first of his two touchdowns. The second touchdown in that first quarter was on a 57-yard drive, engineered and later scored by Ron Calcagni, the quarterback. First and 15, a legal motion, and Barry Switzer has seen his team's chances of a national championship go a-glimmering, but most of these Oklahoma people will be back next year, and they'll be trying for the same national championship next year, and so will Arkansas. Barnabas White. White, with great speed, is dragged down. I tell you, we have seen Phil Tabor, a defensive tackle today, pursue people like White and like Stickers and bring them down from behind.
He's one of those people who'll be back. He's just a junior. And I'll tell you that these are both impressive teams. I'm going out to practice earlier in the week, Jim, and watching them work. It's absolutely amazing to me that you can get that many fine young athletes stacked up on two teams at one time. The more impressive physically, certainly the Oklahoma team, but speed-wise, they're a real matchup.
Second down and 15. Houston Nutt hands the ball off, and Sales carries again. Well, a lot of talk around Miami about the high-scoring Oklahoma offense, and a lot of talk around Miami about the low amount of points given up on an average by Arkansas. And it's the Arkansas defense that has come out on top. James Billings, the president of the Orange Bowl Committee, must be very proud of what has happened tonight. Dan McNamara, the executive director, and Hal Fleming, his production manager, responsible for that
second defense.
Spectacular
second
in lights.
Defense.
Publicity director Gil Sloan, our thanks to the 131 members of the Orange Bowl Committee. Third down. And there goes Sales, and there goes the record as Sales gets inside the 30-yard line. Roland Sales, the sophomore from Fort Worth, Texas, sets the record and puts the game out of reach.
Hey, number two out. Number two out. Number two out. Give me number two out there. The whole two.
Lou Holtz
is
just
the number two out. The number two offense.
Watch the number two offense. He's going to take out Sales now that he's got the record of 195 yards.
Ladar, switch away.
There you heard it. Log R, switch 08. I don't know what it is, but we'll see.
Knee? Ankle?
He's inquiring about the man who was down on the field at the 46-yard line right there. We cannot yet see who it is. Well, from Arkansas, Frank Boyles, who delivered the invocation tonight as the athletic director, Lou Holtz, and Buck Henry, the sports information director. All the folks from Arkansas have been so good to us. And from Oklahoma, Wade Walker, athletic director. Barry Switzer, the head coach, and John Key, the sports information director. They must be disappointed. This man is not disappointed. That's Roland Sales.
What a way to break the record, too. Just popping through and wide open.
I told you I'd be at my best in this one.
Coming off is Mark Lewis, who was filling in for Leotis Harris, who's out with a bad knee and will undergo surgery after the Orange Bowl. And now Lewis comes off. First down at the 25-yard line, 2:32 to go. Barnabas White carries it inside the 25. Well, I tell you, in doing college football, one of the toughest jobs is to spot. If you're Bob Carver of Arkansas, you're thrilled at what the Razorbacks are doing, and you're trying to keep your mind on the game and help me. If you're Travis Lawrence of Oklahoma, you're upset and downcast, but you still got to keep your mind on the job. And both Bob and Travis did an outstanding job. Gentlemen, we thank you, as well as Jack Hoadling, for the statistics tonight, which have been impressive, especially for Roland Sales. From the 23-yard line, second down and 8, less than 2 minutes left. And a tremendous upset in the Orange Bowl. Barnabas White carries the football. An 18-point underdog without its top receiver, without its top running back, is pulling off the upset. And here is a shot we're going to show you in the future Orange Bowls of setting a record.
A record-breaking run by number 21, Sales. He just sails through there, showing some tremendous speed. I don't think anybody knew he had that kind of breakaway speed. That's Zach Henderson, the fine free safety, finally pulling him to the ground. But there it is, 23 carries, 205 yards.
That is official, 205, a 200-yard day. Look out, there goes Barnabas White, touchdown! Oh, the Arkansas Razorbacks will suey pig all over the world tonight. That makes it 30-6.
And there are those around the country who are saying Lou Holtz has got to be the coach of the year. Amazing.
Team was 5-5-1 last year. They will be 11-1 tonight.
I wouldn't let David do it. You can go down on the kickoff.
You did.
You guys did a great job. Hey, you know I love you all, and I wouldn't do anything. I just say, no, don't worry. We got to go, man. You know me, man.
All right, cool. Steve Little, who has also had an outstanding night, adds yet another extra point. And it is Arkansas, 31, Oklahoma, 6. And here goes Barnabas White.
Hand off to White. A beautiful hole blown in there on the left side of that line. And White just legs it into the end zone. Some good blocking on that side of the line by Chuck Kerman and Rick Schumacher. Whoops, I take it back. Second team in there. That's Bill Moon and Mike Burlingame who are blowing that hole open in there.
105 to go. And as we said, Arkansas is going to say, what about us? Now, I know that Notre Dame, down in the ratings, along with Arkansas, defeated Texas today by a lopsided score of 38-10. But here is Arkansas, number 6, defeating number 2, Oklahoma, with designs on the national championship by a score of 31-6. So your number 1 and 2 teams have been knocked off, and the scramble is on, and the scramble will be on between Arkansas, Notre Dame, Texas, Penn State, and Alabama, with Oklahoma and Michigan waiting until next year. And for Barry Switzer, it's incredible to believe that this is only the 5th time that his team has gone down to a defeat since he's been a head coach at the University of Oklahoma.
Well, there are some days, Jim, when you should have stayed in bed. It's been one of those days for Oklahoma.
What a story, both here and in the Rose Bowl. And you've seen the big upsets right here on NBC. And look at Little, another one out of the end zone. Oklahoma was saying that they are a good field position team. They've got to have field position. When they lost to Texas, one of the reasons was, aside from dropping the ball and not having Thomas Locke, they had bad field position because of Erchlaven's kicking. A Little is making sure today they've not had good field position. And they've only scored one touchdown, and that came in the 4th quarter and prevented a shutout after 130 straight games of not being shut out.
Little's punting has not been up to his 44-point-something average. And actually, they've actually had great kickoff, but very little on the punting side today from him. He is a great punter as well as a kicker.
Except for, as Peacock carries the ball, the obvious quick kick that went for 67 yards. Less than a minute to go. You have been looking in on the 44th annual Orange Bowl, and the Razorback Rooters, there are about 15,000 of them, are making their way to the field. They're behind the Arkansas bench right now. Oklahoma did not sell all of its tickets, and Arkansas's Rooters said, we'll take them, and they took them, and they're down here. And as they said, we did not come down to see our team get beaten.
And there are those who look back at this game and say that Oklahoma just didn't take Arkansas seriously enough. They'll have to take them seriously after today.
Oh, Rhodes catches the football across the 35-yard line. Well, they have not played each other since 1926. 51 years have gone by, but I guarantee you, both Oklahoma and Arkansas will remember this 13th meeting of their career. Oklahoma knew that Texas had lost, knew that with a convincing win over Oklahoma, over Arkansas, as they were favored to do, would have a big claim for the national championship. But it didn't happen. 8 seconds, 7. You won't be able to contain these Razorback fans. Here they come out as Clemens carries the football. And he'll be tackled by everybody. Here they come. Arkansas wins in a tremendous upset over number 2 ranked Oklahoma, 31-6. And the national championship is up for grabs. We'll leave that to the pollsters. In the race, Arkansas, Notre Dame, Alabama, Penn State, and Texas, all 11-1 after 12 games, including postseason play.
What a tremendous victory for Lou Holtz and his Razorbacks after being counted out early in the week. And I'm sure Barry Switzer and his Oklahoma troops will go back disappointed. They'll look at the films. They'll say, how in the world could we ever have allowed Arkansas to make us look this way on national television? But I think the credit is for the great play of this Arkansas team. A quick, aggressive, hard-nosed defense, smart defensive coaching, and some excellent long drives early in the game, and then some great impetus from that offensive team in this second half.
And let us not forget Roland Sales with a brand-new Orange Bowl record of 205 yards. But the happiest man has to be Lou Holtz, who said it was a tough coaching decision to suspend those three players, including his leading running back and his leading pass receiver. But he suspended them, he made it stick, and he came down and he won going away from the highly favored Oklahoma Sooners, 31-6. This is Jim Simpson with Merlin Olsen saying goodbye from the Orange Bowl in Miami. And remember, more postseason football on NBC will be the Senior Bowl next Saturday, January the 7th at 2 o'clock. Outstanding college seniors, including the Heisman Trophy winner, Earl Campbell. And then my old buddies will be joining me in Tucson starting tomorrow. And when we wind down the end of the week on Saturday and Sunday, we will be there for golf. Our first tournament of 1978, the first PGA tournament of 1978, the Joe Garagiola Tucson Open. $40,000, the first prize, with Bruce Litsky, the defending champion. Now remember, local news is next on most of these NBC stations, followed by The Tonight Show, starring Johnny Carson, 1/2 hour from now. But as we say goodbye from the Orange Bowl, we must offer our congratulations to Arkansas, to the University of Washington, to the University of Notre Dame, and to the University of Alabama for their excellent wins in today's 4 major bowls. And by and large, it has been a day of upsets, with the number 1 and 2 ranked teams going down to defeat with a national championship within their grasp.
Emergency, an all-new tense movie-length drama about a skyscraper fire, Saturday.